Football Fridays in Georgia, presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia, as we welcome you to historic Weinman Stadium in Cartersville, where tonight the ninth-ranked Hiram Hornets have come to take on the number one-ranked Cartersville Purple Hurricanes in a very big Region 7 5A matchup. And good evening, I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former Auburn Tigers All-American, NFL first-round draft pick, and 15-year pro Wayne Gandy. And Wayne, Cartersville has won four state titles in their 100-year history, two of them in the last decade, while Hiram's won only three playoff games ever in their 20-year history. But they have won 11 of their last 17 games over the last 2 years. They come here tonight with thoughts of an upset.
Man, it's hurricane season out here. You can feel the weather is chilly. Both of these teams like to run the ball. Hiram comes with that confident wing T rush game, and you know, with the big offensive line of Cartersville, they came here to run the ball.
Let's start with Cartersville. I must be in some kind of alternate universe, because Wayne, for the second consecutive week, we're highlighting an offensive lineman at the top of the show. This one's Malachi Tolliver, who's committed to the University of Georgia.
The big right tackle, who's probably an inside lineman on the next level, but when you watch him out there, he's physical, he's confident, he loves to finish. Part of this running game with Richard Houston and Christian Lando, that's 170 a game on average.
Defensive side of the ball, the Hurricanes, number two scoring defense in 5A, led by their linebacker, Connor Brassman.
The leading tackler, the thumper in the middle, 6'2", 220, can get to the outside, come off the edge. What a talent he is. Part of this defense that's stingy. Only 9.1 points a game.
Now, this Hiram team, one of the most talented from a college prospect standpoint in all of 5A, and it's been a dramatic turnaround for their program. You mentioned the wing T. They're averaging 44 points per game, which is number one in 5A, led by their running back, Caden Hamilton.
Mr. Hamilton running the ball, the speedster, loves to get to the edge. One of those guys just want to get out in space. You're talking about an offense that rushes over 270 yards a game. So sit back, relax, get used to the old school game with Mr. Hamilton and his mates.
And they can throw the ball too. They got a four-star wide receiver in Chase Tyler, who's committed to Duke, and he's also a shutdown cornerback.
One of those guys, don't look at the numbers. Only 24 catches, but they're big catches. And on defense, doesn't get a lot of action. They just don't go to his side of the field. But 6'3", 170, what a talent he is.
Hiram and Cartersville should be a fun ball game. Let's get the carousel started and send it off to John Nelson.
Thank you very much, Matt. Good evening to you. Good evening, Wayne. Good evening to all of you. However you are accessing us, hopefully drier than we are, GPBGPB.org and the GPB Sports app. This is the first time Hiram has ever been on Football Fridays in Georgia in club history. And if you look back, even going back to the pandemic, this is a school that basically in a transient community had its enrollment cut in half. They have the chance tonight to match their win total from the last three seasons combined. Coming out of the pandemic, they went 1-9, 1-10, and 5-5. That win tonight could be win number 7 to match what's going on. From the beginning of this run, Coach Fominaya said to his freshmen, stick with it, stick with the process, we can really build something special, and they are one win away from continuing to add to something special in the 2023 season. We'll monitor that from the sidelines here tonight. That's the early story from over here. Hannah, what's going on in your part of the world?
Yeah, John, we'll see what Hiram can do on this rainy, spooky Friday the 13th. We are not only broadcasting live from Weinman Stadium, we are also coming to you from Tyrone, Georgia, for Carver Atlanta versus Sandy Creek. It's our web game. You can watch it on gbb.org/sports or the GBB Sports app. Now, while you're over on that app, don't forget to vote for our poll question of the week, which is, who is going to win this game, Hiram or Cartersville? I will see you guys at halftime. We have a special Make That Kid an Offer segment this week, where one of Cartersville's very own is on that list. And our You Save It Georgia Player Spotlight features a flag football standout. We will talk to the principal. It's all coming up at the half. Until then, Matt and Wayne, take it away, and John and I are going to try to stay dry down here, guys.
Well, it's nice and dry up in the press box, Hannah. Sorry about that. But Wayne, let's bring that into the topic of conversation here. I was out there talking to Connor Foster, the Cartersville coach, before the game. It is a turf field, but turf fields can get slippery too. So how much of an impact does this affect Cartersville and Hiram tonight with it spitting rain right now?
Well, one, with Hiram, especially the way they like to run the ball out of that wing tee, have to be careful with the handoffs and with the big offensive lineman. Can they keep their footing tonight? Will they have to change their cleats to get better traction?
Hiram did win the opening toss, but they have deferred until the second half. So that means we're going to see Cartersville on offense to start this game. And, you know, as you mentioned, Cartersville is Cartersville, one of the best-built programs in the entire state. Solid program. Got a new quarterback this year in sophomore Nate Russell, but a quarterback who saw some snaps last year as well, and they like to run the ball. They got a three-man running back committee, and they like to wear you down in that fourth quarter.
Yeah, Nate Russell is a guy that's definitely a more of a game manager at this point. Like most sophomores are asked to go out and make the right play, make the right call, get this run game and execute as far as reading the defense. So he does a great job with this offensive line. And as you said, the wet conditions, look for them to try to establish the run.
Well, this is a region game. Cartersville is hard to beat in the region. They're 7-0 this season. Wayne, they've won 68 of their last 69 region games dating back to 2011. And we were there last year when they lost that game to Calhoun in triple overtime.
A dominant program. You can see why when you come up here, the fans, the stadium, it's a beautiful place. You really look out here, Matt, and you think you're at a D1 school somewhere with the facilities of the field. So a great program, and Connor Foster, the head coach, have them going great this year at 7-0.
Well, the opening kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seatbelts save lives. And Oliver Castaneda teeing it up for Hiram. He's one of the best in the state. He's been offered by Memphis, a Coles five-star kicker. Interest from Georgia, 50 of his 53 kickoffs this year have been touchbacks.
Excited to see this young man. His coach talks about the ball just booms off his foot. He's going to need to pin this Cartersville offense back in the end zone consistently tonight.
Well, Baylen Long standing deep for the Hurricanes, and this kickoff will not be returnable as it goes all the way through the end zone. A 70-yard kick in the air for Castaneda, and that means that Cartersville will start on offense from the 20-yard line. And there's the aforementioned Nate Russell, the 6'3", 175 sophomore. You see his numbers, 59% for his career, includes last year. 1,459 yards, 16 touchdowns, and 6 interceptions.
Only six interceptions on the season. Not asked to do a lot throwing the ball. And tonight it's about getting in and out of the plays and executing up front for the offensive line.
That's right. The 6 interceptions, that's his career number, including the 4 he threw last year. He's only thrown 2 this year with 9 touchdowns. So Cartersville starts on offense from the 20-yard line. End around on the play going to the wide receiver, Adarian Taylor Wilson, who scored 2 touchdowns in their dramatic victory over Cass last week. Here's a look at that Cartersville offensive line brought to you by Regions Bank. Hogg, Medina, Surrett, Curtis, and Tolliver. Hogg, Surrett, and Tolliver, all college prospects. Lando, the running back, with Bryce, Alemon, Brassfield, and Price, the receivers, the running backs, and the wide receiver and tight end. So second down here. Carry goes to Lando up to the 31-yard line, and that'll be a first down as Christian Lando goes for 7.
Right up the middle right here with Lando. Good blocking in the middle. Surrett, Curtis, Medina. Nice lead block there by Connor Brassfield. We talked about him in the open as more of a defensive player, but he is an outstanding blocker on their offense.
Lando has 5 offers, including Georgia State, Coastal Carolina, and Charlotte. Has rushed for 422 yards this season. That's third best in the region. First and 10. Lando going to get it again. Try the right side. And the safety, Anthony Pittman, comes up to make the tackle as we take a look at Hiram on defense. Brought to you by Regions Bank with Jones, Garland, Hogan, and Petway up front. The linebackers are Swan, Guybe, and Pope. And in the secondary, Tyler, Small, Brown, and Davis. Although it looks like Anthony Pittman, who rotates with Small, is actually in the starting lineup tonight. So second down and 7. Jamari Bryce, the wide receiver, lines up in the Wildcat, going to take the snap. And Bryce comes to the near side. And Bryce is going to get stopped at the 39-yard line. Guybe, the leading tackler for the Hornets, there to make the stop. And it's going to bring up third down and short.
Nice job of Guybe getting off the block here. Cole Crawford, the young freshman there, chipping his way up to the next level. But nice job there by Guybe in the middle, the only a junior, a guy that you have to keep your eye on.
more of a safety type when you look at his size at 5'9", 185, but good escaping blocks and making the play.
Bryce now lined up at wide receiver. He has 22 offers. And the handoff goes to Houston, and Houston has the first down as he dives forward to the 45-yard line. Picks up 6 on the play.
Nice blocking there. We talked about in the open. Malachi Tolliver out on the edge, the big right tackle, securing that edge for Lando right there to cut up field. Nice job of him. Good-looking kid out on the field, Lando, watching him warm up. Good size, strong legs.
Wayne, they've already had 4 guys run the ball on this opening drive. Now the first pass attempt is Rushel. He's going to stand up there and throw, and nearly intercepted at the 44-yard line, in and out of the hands of Chase Tyler.
Very close there, working his way up in the pocket. Good protection initially. Russell working his way up. Nearly went across the line of scrimmage right here. Held the ball for a long time as he's kind of escaping. And then looks like he got caught in between and just decided to do the smart thing, throw the ball away and not lose yards.
Interesting, they throw the ball on first down after success running the ball. Now brings up a 2nd down and 10. And we're going to have movement and a penalty coming up on Hiram.
Prior to the snap, encroachment on the defense. That penalty will be 5 yards, still 2nd down.
Greg Norton is our referee tonight. There's a look at the rest of the great officiating crew working this Region 7 5A matchup. No championship can be decided tonight, but Cartersville would definitely be in the driver's seat if they get a victory. And Hiram would be effectively eliminated from a region championship picture. Ball is fumbled, and Russell gets on top of it. So Nate Russell alertly falls on that ball. Maybe the wet turf had a factor in this thing.
Their ball just never really came up right there. Luke Surrett, not sure. The snap looked like maybe he thought that Russell was underneath center. Russell was in the shotgun.
Yeah.
And he just kind of snapped it back. As a center, you look for that quarterback pressure on your leg to alert you that he's underneath center. Just a misstep right there by Luke Surrett.
8th play of the drive coming up here. Russell going to run it right up the middle. Russell takes a big shot and keeps on going. Across the 50 and down to the 48. Davion Jackson made the stop. One of the Hiram players goes for the kill shot and doesn't knock him down. It's going to be 4th down and 3.
Nice job once again working up in the pocket there is Russell. Didn't feel like going out on the edge, taking the big hit there by Guybe and still getting another couple of yards. Only listed at 175. Good height at 6'3 as a sophomore, 175. Absorbing that hit and still making yards.
4th down and 3, they're going for it. You saw the hard count by Russell trying to draw the Hornets defense off sides. 6 on the play clock. Now down to 5. Handoff goes, and I don't know if he got it or not. He's going to be short. The Hiram defense comes up with a big stop on 4th down, and the ball's going to go over on downs.
Nice job by Isaiah Swan stepping up from that linebacker position, making that play there on Lando, just not letting him get going in the hole. Nice job by the Hornets defense.
So big stop by the Hornets. They'll be on offense when we get back.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Riding down the road and you're doing just fine when a car in front of you crosses over the line. They're in your space, not looking at your face. Distracted drivers all over the place. Say,
we will, buckle up.
Sing it.
Say, we will, buckle up.
Only in Cartersville, Bartow. 3 Smithsonian-affiliated museums, Barnsley Resort, and an authentic downtown full of unique restaurants and shops. The perfect destination for a memorable staycation, only in Cartersville, Bartow.
Welcome back. We're getting some help here. Go ahead, grab the thing. Go ahead, grab the check. There we go.
Thanks to our friends from Signet Time for our $1,500 donation to our friends here at Cartersville hanging out with us. Great friend of GPB, AP, and AD, Daryl DeMassis. Coach, thanks for hanging out with us and being a great host.
John, thank y'all for having us. We appreciate it. We thank GPB for everything they do and Signet for everything they do. And thank you for the check and all y'all do for our athletes. Appreciate it.
Appreciate you very much. Great to be here at historic Weinman Stadium. We'll send it back upstairs to Matt.
All right. Thank you, Nelly. Nine play, 33-yard drive. Wayne, it took 4:21 off the clock, and it stalls after Hiram comes up with a big defensive stop. But that's the Cartersville playbook tonight on offense. They want to hold the ball and keep this high-powered Hiram offense off the field as much as they can.
So trying to sustain a drive there. Coach Foster coming up a little short there, picking up that fourth down, but great aggressiveness by them.
Ryan Strickland, the quarterback, hands off to the fullback, Kendarius Brown, and Brown still chugging all the way down to the 32-yard line. And folks, what you're seeing here is a wing tee offense.
Nice job right there by the fullback, Brown, as coach... His coach talked about just physical power lifter, a guy that really makes this run game go. He is the key to the run game, usually blocking, that time running.
Hamilton on the sweep. Hamilton inside the 25. Peyton Hamilton inside the 5, and that is going to be out of bounds. No, it's going to be a touchdown. Caden Hamilton goes 32 yards. It takes Hiram just 2 plays to get in the end zone.
Great execution of the wing tee here. Catching out on the edge, Clinton Richard, Torian Edge, the right tackle, right guard. Watch 59, get that block there on Brassfield. And once you get this young man out in space, the speedster, the track runner, Hamilton, what a great run, a great extension to get that ball past the pylon.
And you can see how difficult the wing tee can be to defend as Castaneda pumps it through. And just 32 seconds after taking over on offense, Caden Hamilton scores his 16th touchdown of the season to give Hiram the early 7-0 lead.
Just good blocking coming down there. The right tackle kicking out is edge to guard. And this is where you want to get Caden Hamilton out in the open field with the speed that he has, the quickness. Great job, great execution. And that's what this offense does. Trying to stop a wing tee is more about preparation. You don't have a lot of days. Very few teams run it. It's hard to assimilate it in practice. And right now, after 2 plays, 2 big runs for a touchdown.
Wayne, there's a time when almost all teams ran a wing tee, and it's kind of gone into the dustbin of history as teams have transitioned into spread offenses, which plays right into the hands of Coach Pete Fominaia, who installed this offense 2 years ago. It's difficult to get ready for when you only have 3 days of practice that week to get ready for.
Difficult for your defense and for you to get your scout team offense to run it at the speed of the opponent. And right there, great execution by Hiram.
So Castaneda with another booming kickoff. Coach Fominaia says the ball screams off his foot and it almost hit the front row of the bleachers behind the end zone. And Wayne, let's take a look at your keys to the game. They're brought to you by Breda Pest Management, official pest control of high school football.
Want to take control up front with the offensive line. Control the line of scrimmage. Your offensive line against their defensive line. We saw on that first drive until that fourth down play there. The line was executing on for defense for Hiram. Find Jamari Bryce. He is the key. He is the big play guy down the field. They're trying to set up that play action to get him the ball. Find number 3 and put double coverage on him.
And Coach Connor Foster already lined up Bryce in a wildcat to get him more touches. They felt like they just haven't gotten him enough touches this season. Ball goes to Bryce right away, and he gets tackled in the open field by Willie A.J. Brown, the free safety.
Nice job out there in the open field by Brown. Comes in this game with 46 tackles. The coach of the secondary has been a very bright spot for this defense, making plays first year starting. But look at him. When you're able to tackle a guy like Bryce out in the open field like that, what a great job by him.
Bryce has been offered by Vandy, Louisville, Cincinnati, and Oregon. You saw his career number, 69 catches. That was number 70. 17th catch of the season. Russell stands in the pocket, delivers downfield. It's caught in stride and up to the 50-yard line. A big gainer right there as Bryce comes right back at him and gets the ball to midfield.
Great throw there by Nate Russell, but better blocking up front. Look at this pocket. This play, long developing play. such a clean pocket to throw and deliver that ball. Find number three. That is a key to the game. You got to keep Jabari Bryce for making those kind of plays in that situation.
29-yard pickup for Jabari Bryce. You see his recruiting info, and he's just a junior. First and 10, ball is across midfield, and Lando right up the middle. Christian Lando picks up a first down.
Once again, Cole Crawford, number 27, the freshman coming in with a key kickout block right there, springing. Look at that hole in the middle of the defense. Nice job, Jaden Curtis, the right guard, blocking down Christian Lando. Kind of old school running back, downhill, one cut, physical runner.
Has rushed for over 1,000 yards in his career. Number two back to Malachi Jeffries a year ago, who rushed for over 1,300 yards
prior
and now
snap,
a freshman.
False start on the offense. That penalty is 5 yards, still first down.
And Jeffries now a freshman at the University of Chattanooga. As you take a look at Connor Foster, he's in his fifth season as the Purple Hurricanes head coach. 53-6 is his record since taking over for Joey King, who we saw last week here on Football Fridays in Georgia, now the head coach at Carrollton. Russell, heavy rush is coming. He gets it out of there, and it's going to be incomplete. Big rush coming off the edge from Zion Jones.
Nice job of Jones just bringing the pressure off the edge, trying to set up the screen out here to Lando. Just that initial pressure as an offensive tackle. You're trying to give ground, but you don't want to give ground that fast. If you Langston Hall, the left tackle on Zion Jones, just no time to get that set up and execute it to get the ball to Lando.
Jones is a junior prospect. He stepped in after Caleb Eicher got hurt a couple of weeks ago against Dalton. Pass downfield and broken up by Willie Brown. Trying to get the ball to Adarian Taylor Wilson, who had the two touchdowns last week against Cass, including the game winner in overtime.
Nice technique there by Willie Brown, just never leaving the quarterback eyes. He's reading this all the way. Good break on the ball. 6'1", about 155. Nice job knocking that down, keeping it away from Taylor Wilson. Good protection once again, trying to go for the big play down the field with Nate Russell.
Third and 15. This is a Cartersville offense averaging 29 points per game, 310 total on the ground, 171 on the ground, and 138 in the air. Russell, heavy rush, going to take a sack back at the 40-yard line. Deontay Petway, third quarterback sack of the season for the 6'4", 225 senior.
Mr. Petway, the guy for this defense. When there's a play that needed to be made, look for number 90. Coming on a TE stunt right there, back tracing his steps to bring down Nate Russell.
They haven't brought the punter on yet. Ryan Johnson is their punter, and he's a very good one, one of the best in the state, and a pitcher committed to the University of Georgia. And they're going for it already on fourth down again. They failed their first time, and this is fourth and 17 going for it. Lined against the 23. Surprised they don't try to kick him deep. Now, the backup quarterback, Andrew Purdy.
Delay a game
is in
on the offense. That penalty is 5 yards, still fourth down.
So now they bring Ryan Johnson on to punt.
Down in distance at that point, even if you get offside, that's only 5 yards. It still would have been fourth and forever in this situation, and you definitely don't want to give Hiram the short field once again. Taking the penalty, punting the ball.
Johnson averages 40.8 yards per punt. That's number three in 5A. It's number one in the region, and his net is 39.8. So very little return. He angles to the sideline and going to hit near the hash and roll dead inside the 10-yard line at the 5. What a punt by Ryan Johnson. That's his 10th punt this season that he has pinned inside the 20-yard line. Hiram back on offense when we get back.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna Healthcare. Cigna Healthcare is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna Healthcare's mission is to improve the health and vitality of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is all about Georgians standing together for substance misuse prevention. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
At TELUS Science Museum, the magic of discovery is larger than life. With tons of interactive exhibits and stunning visuals, come experience the magic of TELUS.
You're a go for landing, over.
Welcome back to Weinmann Stadium, 414 for the first. As always, it is a multi-screen experience here at Georgia Public Broadcasting. The web game tonight, one of the toughest regions around. You think this one's tough? How about one that's tough in AAA? We are showing Carver and Sandy Creek. They are second quarter. Carver's leading that one by the score of 7-0. Matt, we saw Carver up against Buford earlier this season. All four of these teams in this region in AAA should make some noise come season three. We'll keep an eye on that one all night long back upstairs.
Well, there's no doubt about it, John. Last year it was Sandy Creek beating Cedar Grove, region rival in the state championship. Carver Atlanta got to the semifinals. Year before that, Carver Atlanta played in the state finals against Cedar Grove as Caden Hamilton on the first run of this drive. Just the third play, Wayne, that Hiram has run so far in this quarter. Cartersville's run 15, but the Hornets lead 7-0.
Explosive offense Hiram brings to the field, and right there you can see with Caden Hamilton, only a 3 or 4 yard gain, but you can see his ability to make people miss in space.
Handoff goes to Deshaun Williams, and they're going to get to him at the 6 yard line. Great pursuit by the Cartersville defense that time. As we take a look at Hiram on offense, it's brought to you by Regions. Riggs and Richard, their tackles are D1 prospects. Dudley Thomas and Edge in the middle in the interior. And then you've got Williams, Hamilton, and Brown as the running backs, Tyler the wide receiver, and Walter Matthews, who's the number 2 rated tight end in the entire country, according to ESPN, and committed to Southern Cal. And we haven't even talked about him yet.
Ryan Strickland having a conversation with the white hat. Clock clicking down for Hiram.
Strickland scrambling and gonna fumble the ball, scramble for it at the 15-yard line. Let's see who has it. Cartersville's got it.
Martavius Cochran, big collision right there with Ryan Strickland. And we see the wet conditions here on this, just losing his footing. Connor Bransfield had a hand in there, maybe knocked the ball away. Can't see if his knee was down, but they rule it a fumble right there. Just slipping, ball coming out, big collision there. You can see that wet ball bouncing around.
I think it was Richard Houston who came up with the fumble recovery. And Strickland, the quarterback, is down on the play. It was hard to tell whether he had possession of the ball as he slipped and went down and his knee hit the ground. But I suspect upon seeing the replay twice, not getting conclusive evidence, I probably did not have control of the ball as he was going down. Let's check in with John.
Yeah, it happened right here in front of me, and right now they're doing the vision test with the physio. They're making sure that he can follow along on the fingers. As he tried to make his cut, Matt, it's a point that you and Wayne had been making about this surface and this miss, because you can't make the hard cut that you're used to making. You're going to spin out. That's what happened here in this play. And also for Cartersville on the defensive side of things, Martavius Cochran came up a little worse for wear as well. So it was one on each side, but obviously the concern for Coach Fominaya right now is about a starting QB.
So they continue to check out Ryan Strickland, their first-year starting quarterback, who transferred to Hiram from Mount Perrin.
And on that play, Matt, it seemed like it was more that his head maybe got snatched back than it was a big hit on it. Right here as he slips, I think you see Cochran.
Now, I think the ground forced the fumble, quite frankly, upon seeing the replay again.
As he turns the corner, pursuit.
Or maybe not.
It's a bang bang play
Bransfield
right there.
Yeah, Bransfield got his hand on the ball and maybe had knocked it loose and he did not have control on it. It's hard to tell. Very play, like you just said, a bang bang play. Bransfield got his hands on the ball and then he lost it. But of greater concern right now for Hiram is their quarterback situation. So watch Brassfield, 44, come in there and swipe at the ball. And I think he got his hands on it. And then when he hit the ground, it was out. So even if we had replay for the regular season, don't know that it would reverse the call or maybe just confirm the call. And I've seen that replay a number of times now, and I still don't know what happened. And other than the ball did come out.
In a call like that, it's all about what the referees called on the field.
Yep.
It's about proving whatever was called on the field with inconclusive evidence to reverse it.
So but the backup quarterback is Ethan Lattimore, a 6'1", 150 sophomore who has a very limited sample size of offense. And we'll see what happens when he gets back out there. But Cartersville recovers the fumble, and they have the ball at the 14-yard line. Right up the middle and very little gain.
Deontay Petway once again, number 90. He's their big play guy, 6'4". 225, he's long, high motor. Nice job of him slipping that tackle and hitting the running back in the backfield.
Christian Lando with the short game. Gonna bring up second down and 10, practically no game. We'll call it zero, second down and 10. 2 minutes to play here in the opening quarter. Cartersville trying to get on the board. They dump it off to Brassfield. Brassfield inside the 10 and down to the six. Connor Brassfield. Offered by the University of the South, Swanee, sixth catch of the year for the tight end.
All about the play action here. Brassfield pretending as though he's going to kick out the end, slips to the field, out in the field. Nice job of him catching the ball. Just a do-all kind of player, as Coach Foster laughed about with us, a guy who thinks that he can play any position on the field.
Thinks he's the best wide receiver, thinks he's the best running back on the team. But Coach Foster added, this is the kind of guy that our program is all about, throwback player.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense. That penalty is 5 yards. Still third down.
So third and two just became third and seven.
The one thing that Cartersville has given themselves a great chance to control this game is they have established the run. Nate Russell is able to work off of the play action fake. Good job by the offensive line so far, creating some holes for Lando.
So it's third down and a long six. They've got to get to the four.
Timeout, Cartersville. That is their first charge timeout of the half.
So Cartersville stops the clock with 1:29 to play here in the first quarter. And they've been their own worst enemy. Three penalties now for 15 yards, Wayne.
And that's the thing. I would think the coach wants to make sure he gets great execution. And when they've been in this situation, they've had penalties even two plays ago to put them behind the sticks of staying on schedule for them. Coach Foster understands against this high-powered offense, he doesn't know what's going on with the quarterback situation for Hiram. He needs to get in the end zone.
Let's take a look at the team resume for the Cartersville Purple Hurricanes. It's brought to you by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids. Four-time state champions, most recently back-to-back in 2015 and 16, won 68 of their last 69 region games, 23 region championships. Their streak of 10 in a row snapped last year. They have the number two scoring defense in 5A at 9.1 points per game, and this is the 110th season of Cartersville football going back to 1909.
68 out of 69 seems like a misprint. You really feel like you got to Google that and make sure it's right. What dominance that shows for the Purple Hurricanes.
So third down, coming out of the timeout, ball is thrown, touchdown to Brassfield. Crank up the purple LED lights to celebrate. 11-yard touchdown pass from Nate Russell to Connor Brassfield, and it's 7-6.
And this is all about being able to run the play action. Once again, we saw earlier in this drive Connor Brassfield sneak out to the flat, this time faking as though he's going to kick out on the end, running straight down the field, just running down the hashes. Nice job, wide open. Nate Russell being patient, letting him get open and delivering the ball.
So that was a three-play, 14-yard drive following the fumble recovery by Richard Houston. Ryan Johnson is on to kick. 27 of 28 this season on the PATs.
Prior to the snap, encroachment on the defense. That penalty half the distance. Still one untimed down.
Let's see if they go for it, getting half the distance, whether they go for two here. We saw Walton do this a couple of weeks ago when they got a similar penalty.
Coach Foster is going to wave it off and go ahead on and take the punt, take the extra point. Now he's changing out personnel on the PAT, which is interesting. Now, never really seen that. Taking players out, rotating on PATs.
Snapper is Braxton Kitchens, the holder Logan Shrewsbury, and the kick by Ryan Johnson is up and good. We're tied at seven.
Good job by the offense, taking the turnover, punching it in for seven, getting this game tied. That man right there, Connor Brasfield, with two big catches, one for a touchdown on that drive, just running down the seam for that last touchdown from Nate Russell. Guess he's trying to prove to Coach Foster he does has the best hands on the team.
Scoring drive, Governor's Red Ribbon campaign scoring drive. Three plays and 14 yards. Nate Russell has started this game 4 for 7, 51 yards and a touchdown here in the first quarter. That was the 10th touchdown pass of the season for Nate Russell. So Ryan Johnson has it teed up and ready to kick it off. And Johnson's done a good job too. 30 of his 33 kickoff attempts have been touchbacks, 91%. We got two phenomenal kickers here tonight. Kick from Johnson, arcing high, and it's going to be taken in the end zone, which makes it non-returnable. So Hiram brings it out to the 20-yard line with 83 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Wayne, let's take a look at the keys to the game.
Already
brought to you by Breda Pest Management.
Already important was Hiram being able to run the ball now with maybe an injury at quarterback with Ryan Strickland. Even more important that they get this run game going based on who they put in at quarterback. And for Cartersville, big play. We saw in that first drive for the touchdown, they gave away two big plays. They have to make this offense, who runs a different wing T offense, but they have to make them drive the ball, make them earn each and every down.
John, what you got on the update?
It is Ethan Lattimore out at quarterback watching the physio. Keep an eye on Ryan Strickland. And it was follow along, check the pupils, check the motion. Not satisfactory answers. That's why Lattimore's back in there. And it looks like that Strickland's done for the night.
That's a shame for Strickland and the Hiram offense. And we'll see how well Ethan Lattimore can hand off the ball, because that's a big part of their offense. But they lose a great arm in Ryan Strickland, who threw for 247 yards against Calhoun last week.
It has the ability to extend plays, work in the pocket when they do throw the ball. So now Ethan Lattimore in this rush game has to get going in a big way.
Kendarius Brown out to the 50-yard line. How about Kendarius Brown? That's his third big carry of the game.
The dirty worker right there, getting out on the edge. No more for his physical workhorse. Here showing you the speed out in the open field. Great execution once again, creating that edge. Clinton Richard, the Wake Forest right tackle, number 65. Darius Brown, the power lifter, showing you the speed.
Yeah, he was the GACA state champion in the 200 weight class in powerlifting. First and 10 after a 27-yard gain. And that's Deshaun Williams. And Williams crashes down to the 44-yard line as we take a look at Cartersville defense. Brought to you by Regions Bank with Cochran, McCarthy, and Hamilton up front. The four-man linebacking crew, Lando, McBride, Brasfield, and Houston. And in the secondary, Bryce, Cooley, Abernathy, and Lynn. So second down. Ball is fumbled again, and this time they jump on top of it. And that's something that you might expect with a change at quarterback, especially on a wet night like this.
So Luke Surrett for Cartersville, and now Trevion Thomas, just ball not getting back right there, sticking on the wet turf.
And that was the final play of the first quarter. So Ethan Lattimore, the sophomore, has been thrust into the spotlight here on GPB. We got a 7-7 game as we head to the second quarter on a rainy night in Cartersville.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable. Naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
Only in Cartersville, Bartow. Three Smithsonian affiliated museums, Barnsley Resort, and an authentic downtown full of unique restaurants and shops. The perfect destination for a memorable staycation, only in Cartersville, Bartow.
Start of the second quarter in Cartersville, the Purple Hurricanes and Hiram tied at 7 here on GPB. Pete Fominaia in his sixth season as the Hornets head coach, 23-37 after a successful run in Florida. Here's a look at the Hiram resume, brought to you by DBHDD. This is their first winning season since 2014. They've already locked that up. Only 3 all-time playoff ones, 1 region title. That was in 2011. They have the number one scoring offense in all of 5A and a program that started 24 seasons ago in 2000. And it's 3rd down and 9 for the Hornets as we begin the second quarter. Ball is fumbled into the air, and Hamilton plucks it out of the air. Hamilton follows his big blocker, and down to the 38-yard line is going to have the first down. How about big Jameson Riggs, the commit to Georgia Tech, out there blocking for him, but there is a flag down.
I think we're going to get a hold out here
on the offense. That pin will be 10 yards. From the spot of the foul, replay, 3rd down.
Deshaun Williams, number 6, out here on the edge on Reed Zell holding. Really didn't expect right there. I don't know that Caden Hamilton was supposed to get this ball here. Watch number 6 getting out on the edge. Good blocking. Right there, you see. Actually, it's Torian Edge holding Kristen Lando. Possibly right there out in the open field. Easy for the referee to call.
Possibly could have had a block in the back on Jameson Riggs, too, the Georgia Tech commit. There were a number of options there to call on that flag that was dropped. Hiram, 86 yards on the ground so far through one quarter of play and none through the air. But it's 3rd down now and 14 after the penalty erased the 1st down. To the air, Lattimore completes it to Williams, and Williams trying to get back, gets a 1 yard on the play, tried to curl back into the middle, and it's going to be 4th down.
Nice job of the defense rallying and making this tackle there. You can see the blue, the purple jerseys actually breaking on the ball. Good job by Richard Houston, making the runner cut back in to the traffic and bringing him down.
So 4th down, and Castaneda on to punt. He's got a 35.9 average, which is 9th in 5A and number 2 in the region behind Ryan Johnson of Cartersville.
Another false start here, pre-snap penalty.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense. That penalty 5 yards, still 4th down.
continues to rain here. It's not a heavy rain. It's a misty rain, but it's been raining now for a good hour plus. So fourth down and very long. Castaneda gets it out of there. Might have been deflected. Ball coming down at the 42-yard line. I think Cartersville got a piece of that.
Big time pressure right here up in the middle by the Purple Hurricanes, just getting a piece of the ball. Only takes a little touch of the ball to throw it off right there.
Yeah, Kelson Mitchell, number 15, just got a fingertip on it. That punt only goes 12 yards. And so now Cartersville back on offense. First and 10 from the 45. Play action, Russell, Bryce catches it in stride, streaks through the defense, makes a cutback, and there he goes. Touchdown, Cartersville.
Jamari Bryce, the big time playmaker, the junior. Nice find there by Nate Russell. Working the route tree out on the edge. Adrian Taylor Wilson running the safety back, finding Bryce underneath. And then the explosion of speed right there. We talked about one of the big keys for Hiram was the ability to keep the ball away from Mr. Jamari Bryce. Big time play right there by that young man.
Kick by Johnson is through the uprights. Wow, Jamari Bryce exploded. 11th career touchdown catch for Jamari Bryce. Watch him go. 55 yards, caught the slant, and it was bye-bye, baby. 14-7, Purple Hurricane.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Welcome back to Weinman Stadium. It is a minute 26 gone, second quarter, 14-7. The home team in front. Let's check in on our multi-screen experience tonight. Over on GPB.org and the GPB Sports app, Carver and Sandy Creek from the battleground in Tyrone. Under 3 minutes to go, first half. 7-7, Carver, Atlanta, Sandy Creek. We would not have anticipated anything different from this match over on the website. Wiley Ballard on the bark for us tonight over on GPB.org and the GPB Sports app. Our web game all season long brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management. Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football. Matt, back upstairs to drier environs.
Stop complaining. Thanks, Nelly. Stay dry, best you can. Doing a great job down there in the wet stuff. So Hiram set to get the ball back. Now they're down a touchdown after they scored on their second snap of the game. Ryan Johnson's kick is going to go through the back of the end zone. We've seen three kicks tonight go all the way through the end zone.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to get any return yardage tonight by either team. These two kickers are outstanding. Big legs for both of them, but what an explosive drive there. Nice read by Nate Russell. Cartersville getting that ball to Jamari Bryce, and now this Hiram offense has to kind of settle down. We've seen them with penalties and turnovers, getting behind the sticks, and when you run the wing T, that is definitely not where you can be in second and third and long.
Deshaun Williams. And Strickland's back out there, quarterback. How about that? Ryan Strickland, who Nelson thought might be done for the night, and certainly given the hit that he took and the test that they were running, but apparently he has recovered. He's back out there. Good news for Hiram.
Gives them that ability to try to start working the ball to Chase Tyler and Walter Matthews and some of these 50-50 balls.
Pocket stands up. Going to heave it downfield, and a great catch made at the 39-yard line. What a catch by Walter Matthews, the four-star tight end committed to Southern Cal.
You have this kind of talent, Matt, you have to dial it up at some point. Nice job of protection initially, waiting for his tight end to come across the field, just giving him a chance, throwing it up high at 6'6", 6'7", 245. Great hand catch here. Just part of that new generation of tight end that can work down the field.
Kendarius Brown gets the toss. Bounces off a couple of defenders. Kendarius Brown down the sideline. Touchdown, Hiram. But there is a flag down back at the 46.
You can see the body language of Hiram. The sideline looking like they feel like those flags are on them. Let's see how it turns out. Great job, Kadarius Brown.
So it appears a 61-yard touchdown run by Kadarius Brown is going to be erased.
Block in the back on the offense. That penalty will be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
You talk about costly penalties. When you take points off the board, that's a tough one.
Right here.
Watch 55 right there. There's the block in the back. Travion Thomas. Nice jumped the defender in the back, and that's a penalty.
Trying to spring his runner free, hustling to the ball. Just wrong angle right there for Thomas, hitting the defender in the back. Big play for this offense, but it shows you once again how explosive these backs are for the Hornets.
So now it's going to be first and 14, and another penalty.
Prior to the snap, false start. On the offense, that penalty is 5 yards. Replay first down.
So now first and 19.
Pre-snap penalties for both of these teams have kind of hampered drives, big plays right there, call back, and now really behind the sticks. First and 19 for wing team offense. Just hard to make those kind of plays, but they have the kind of runners. And as I said, getting the ball out to Walters, Matthews, and Chase Tyler.
Caden Hamilton going to pick up a few yards on the play. Tough defense out there on the edge. Luke McBride, the linebacker, first guy to hit him.
McBride, 6 feet, 220. Cartersville has some big linebackers in there when you talk about Brassfield at 220 as well. Kristen Lando, 200. A lot of size to try to stop this running attack.
Pocket for Strickland, going deep for Tyler, and nearly intercepted, and a flag out. Bryce might be called for the DPI.
One-on-one matchup here.
That's best-on-best matchup right there.
And that is Chase Tyler. You have to get this young man involved into the game at some point.
Pass interference on the defense. That penalty is 15 yards, resulting in a first down.
Finally getting a one-on-one matchup out on the edge. Jamari Bryce only at 5'11", fighting for everything right there, but two of the top talents for their team. That's that matchup we've been waiting on down the field. See who can win in those situations. Airing it out there is Ryan Strickland. And I think that's the thing about getting him back. He gave you the ability to throw the ball down the field back to the Hiram offense.
As far as penalties go, not the worst in the world because it's a mark off, not a spot foul. Better than getting up a touchdown right there. Handoff goes to Williams. Williams crashes out to the edge. And Williams is going to get the ball to about the 45, 44-yard line.
You missed the direction right there when you talk about the wing T. Ryan Strickland doing a great job of deceiving who he's handing the ball off. As you can see here, who has the ball? And there it is, finally given to Deshaun Williams. Those are the kind of plays we talked about with his offense. The defense just doesn't have time in a week to really study. It's hard on the defense to stop.
You can see how a defense's head is spinning on a play like that, trying to defend this wing T offense. Brassfield comes up with the tackle right there in the middle. Or was that Hamilton? Might have been Ali Hamilton. But it's going to be third down either way on a short gain for Hiram. And the carry by Jamarian Watley. Third down and four. Williams in motion, going to get the handoff, trying to get to the edge, and he's not going to get there. Hurricanes rally to the ball, and it's going to be fourth down.
A lot of bodies on the spot this time. No one fooled. Layden Heath right there. You can see Ali Hamilton. Nobody is fooled this time. They see Deshaun Williams with the ball. Nice tackle to keep him short of the sticks, and it looks like the Hornets are considering going for it again here on fourth down.
It is fourth and four. The line to gain is the 40. Strickland, heavy rush coming at him. Going to scramble and run for the first down and get it. Going out of bounds at the 35-yard line, make it the 34. Heads-up play by Strickland, who just a few minutes ago got knocked out of the game.
Great job by Strickland. Better play here by Caden Hamilton, number three, coming back to knock this in right there, just knocking Layden Heath off his track, allowing his quarterback to get out on the edge, showing you that toughness to recover in this game. Bounce back Ryan Strickland, showing the toughness for the senior to make that play.
So first and 10, inside handoff, and that's Watley down to the 31-yard line. And going back, actually, that was Hamilton, not Watley, number three, on the inside handoff. Going to bring up second down. But going back to that run there by Strickland, that was one of the things that, you know, Coach Fulminaya said about his quarterback is when he gets into a jam, he can get out of it in a hurry. He has that ability.
6'1", 185, very athletic. Has had a great season for his team as far as game managing. And you could see the different ways he has to hand the ball off.
And Strickland got hit by his own man and stumbles down to the 31-yard line while Martavius Cochran makes the tackle. And it's going to be fourth down, and hopefully he's okay. He's slow to get up.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to take him out here, Matt. You could see his body position right there. Big hit there by Montravius Cochran. Looks like maybe he's a signal. He lost some feeling in his arms there. It was a big hit there as the big DN worked down. Clean hit. But after that first time leaving the game, you could see his body just is reacting to that hit right there. Scary sight for that young man.
Mm-hmm. No doubt. Second time they've had to stop the game to go look at Ryan Strickland. There's another look at it.
You can see Zero come out of your screen right here with the big hit right there.
And the head and snaps head on the ground again.
The turf.
I think now he's motioning at his legs. And it's, you're right. I mean, he's gripping his fist and flexing his fingers. So perhaps a little bit of a stinger.
And on the first time when he fumbled the ball, and it seemed, that's why I said, it looked like it was more that his neck got snapped back. So maybe that was initially what they took him out for, some kind of stinger in his neck. And then the big hit there by Cochran.
You can see he is none too happy. He doesn't want to come out of the game. You can see he is not happy at all having to come off the field. He's frustrated, dejected, shown a lot of guts to get back out there after taking that big hit earlier in the game. So hopefully he can recover, get back in there, but safety first. Third down and 7.
You notice how the Hurricane defense playing off the ball. They have to see. You have the outside linebackers playing. They want to see these handoffs so they can make the play.
Lattimore back in there, quarterback, and a handoff to Brown, and he gets stopped right at the line of scrimmage. That's Kelson Mitchell, who had the partially blocked punt earlier. I think that was 15 in on the tackle.
Only a 3-man front. Kelson Mitchell playing off the ball, playing off instincts in that situation. Looks like they're going to try for a long field goal here.
Castaneda has the leg. Coach Fomanaya says that he can hit it from 60. The fly in the ointment is they lost their long snapper a couple of weeks ago to a broken leg, so they've got a new long snapper in there, Caden Doyle. 47-yard kick. Everything works perfectly so far, and the kick is up and through the uprights. No problem. A 47-yard boot straight through the uprights for Oscar Castaneda. And it's 14-10 with 5:19 to play in the half.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is all about Georgians standing together for substance misuse prevention. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
At TELUS Science Museum, the magic of discovery is larger than life. With tons of interactive exhibits and stunning visuals, come experience the magic of TELUS.
Houston, you're a go for landing. Over.
Welcome back to Weinman Stadium. It's Hiram versus Cartersville. Canes up 14-10. Here we are just a few minutes away from halftime. And coming up on that region's halftime show, we will have a special Make That Kid an Offer segment with one of the Canes' very own players featured. The You Save It Pharmacy Georgia Player Spotlight features a flag football standout. We'll hear from the principal. We will break down games with John across the state. This rain is really affecting scores. So I will see you guys in just a few minutes for all of that. Matt.
Thank you, Hannah. Look forward to that. That Make That Kid an Offer, GPB Sports staple the last couple of years, and Hannah doing a great job with that at halftime. So stick around to see who gets spotlighted this week. Castaneda going to kick it off again, and once again, this one's coming down a little bit shorter than the pass, but still in the end zone for a touchback. So they bring it out to the 20. With 5 minutes, a little bit more than that, left here in halftime. 10 play, 50-yard drive. The Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign, that's a 50-yard field goal drive to get a 47-yard field goal from Castaneda. And Coach Pete Fomanaya and the Hiram Hurricanes hanging around, trailing Cartersville 14-10. They've never beaten them. This is the fourth consecutive year that they have played. The second time they've played here at Weinman Stadium. Russell going to pitch it here and run by Christian Lando. Gets about a yard on the play.
Getting back to the rush game for the Purple Hurricanes and everything they've had successfully today. The two big passes for touchdowns, Brassfield and to Bryce, has come off play action fakes. And that's what they have established early. That was one of their keys. They wanted to be able to run the ball, stay ahead of the sticks.
Coach Connor Foster says he's seen grit from his team the last 2 weeks. Cartersville's basically won in the last minute of the last two games they played, come from behind victory to beat Calhoun last week in overtime against Cass. And another tight one here tonight. Russell up top looking for his wide receiver. And a Darian Taylor Wilson could not bring it in. Good tight coverage there by the Hornets.
Nice job, Willie Brown, the safety, covering on Taylor Wilson, who had a big game last week, running step for step. Didn't get his head around to find the ball, but didn't run into the receiver as he went to make the catch right there. It's going up top once again, Nate Russell.
Russell played last year as a freshman, played in 19 of their 40 regular season quarters last year, splitting time with Paul Gamble, who was the starter and graduated out of the program. But another line, a long line of very promising Hurricane quarterbacks that have come through this program. First and foremost, Trevor Lawrence. Pass going up top, and it's caught by Marchese. Brady Marchese hauls it in inside the 35-yard line.
Just a go route by Marchese on Brandon Davis, using that height at 6 feet to conquer Davis, who's 5'6 here. Good protection, good ball here to air it out there, leading the receiver. Nice job catching that ball by Marchese over the shoulder.
43-yard catch by Marchese. Christian Lando barrels up the middle for the Cartersville touchdown.
Great blocking off that right side, Curtis and Tolliver. But Mr. Lando, known for his size and his strength, watch how he leads Willie Brown here. Watch this move right there. Just that move by the big fellow in the middle of the field. Willie Brown really had no chance coming through that hole that fast. Running back up on him too fast. One cut on Willie Brown to the end zone.
Ryan Johnson, the PAT. And Cartersville has a 21-10 lead. Christian Lando with his 10th rushing touchdown of the season.
Just no chance there for the safety. Good job there. Jaden Curtis blocking down. Luke Zarette there in the middle. Malachi Tolliver. Christian Lando, big physical running back. 6'1", about 200 pounds. Panthers down the heart of the defense, right at the safety, Willie Brown. Had no chance.
Georgia State Panthers right down the road in Atlanta. Got a big game against Marshall tomorrow night. They're taking a look at this young man. They've offered him 21 career touchdowns for Christian Lando. So two big plays on that scoring drive. A 43-yard pass from Russell to Marchese, and then the 35-yard touchdown by Lando. And the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign scoring drive, four plays, 80 yards, and now an 11-point lead for the Purple Hurricanes. Line drive kick, and this will not be returnable as it gets by and into the end zone. So Hiram will take over at the 20. Let's see who's going to be out there at quarterback. My guess is it's going to be back at Lattimore here after Strickland had to leave the game for a second time as we check in with John Nelson.
Conversation with the physio. Parents had the conversation with the physio, and Matt, Ryan Strickland basically yelled his lungs out through his helmet as he was leaving on that last situation. Physio had a conversation with him, parents had a conversation to console, and then Lattimore and Strickland had a bit of a conversation on their own. Now I think he's done for the night.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, but it's the best thing for him if he's not physically able to get back out there to avoid any further more serious injury. Deshaun Williams gets dropped for a loss. That's a TFL for number 48, Luke McBride, on the play.
Nice job of McBride working down, not letting Williams get out on the edge. And right now this Hiram offense is going to have to attack this defense. They're playing off the ball, only a three-man front. I know you like to get out on the edge and use your speed. You're going to have to really go right at this defense.
Pass is complete to Tyler. And Tyler, short gain on the play. Just the first catch for Chase Tyler, the four-star wide receiver committed to Duke, rated as high as the number 13 wide receiver in the country. Chose the Blue Devils over 26 other offers, including Georgia Tech and Tennessee. Tennessee offered him as a cornerback. Lattimore in there, quarterback, and he shot puts the ball out there to Tyler, too high for him, and it's going to be fourth down. Chase, didn't want to do that.
Chase Tyler, and that's the thing with this offense. If they get behind the sticks, even when Ryan Strickland in there, the offense, when you run a wing T, is not really built for second and third and long, and now you have your backup quarterback. You're going to have more success on first and second down running the ball. Great job there by the Purple Hurricane defense, keeping everything in front of them.
Castaneda, end over end kick, hits at the 47 and bounces away from Shrewsbury, who thought about picking it up and then thought wisely not to. And the ball is down at the 30-yard line. That's a 46-yard punt by Castaneda.
He came in the game expecting the Hiram offense with the explosive plays. In this first half, it's been about Nate Russell and his explosive plays down the field, throwing the ball, that last drive, getting the ball down to Marchese, the big touchdown to Bryce, and Kristen Lando running the ball. So explosive plays all around for the Purple Hurricanes on offense.
Nate Russell has already thrown two touchdown passes here in the first half. 7 of 11 for 151. Houston on the carry to the far side, and Houston going to get submarined. Just a one-yard gain on the play.
You see this offense now stepping into spreading out Hiram, playing out on the edge, trying to get that soft box right there, handing it off to Richard Houston. Another one of those big physical two-way players, running backs that play tight end and running backs that play linebacker.
And Houston's been offered by the University of the South, Swanee. Head coach Andy McCullum got him off to a great start. Russell going to sidearm it downfield, intercepted at the 49-yard line by Chase Tyler. Tyler takes it to the far side and driven out of bounds. And Chase Tyler comes up with his second interception of the season with a 24-yard return, and the Hornets are back in business.
What a time to make a big play here. Initially, good protection here. Nate Russell trying to. And when you have a talent like Chase Tyler, you just cannot go over there like that. That's why teams stay away from him. He's that kind of playmaker. At 6'3", feeling the pressure, getting out of the pocket. Need to throw this ball away. Just stepping into it, getting off his receiver, stepping in front of that for the big interception.
So now the Hornets back on offense with Lattimore at quarterback. Deshaun Williams with the carry. Williams going to get about 3 on the play, down close to the 20, spotted at the 21.
3-4 yards, running the ball on first down. That's what you have to do when you have your backup quarterback in there. Stay ahead of the stick so he can operate. Give yourself a chance that on third down, third and shorts, he can make plays, or you can throw something quick out to Matthews or Tyler.
That's a look at Tyler's defensive stats. And Hamilton on the carry gets spun to the ground.
Nice job again. Layden Heath, the backup middle linebacker, slicing through the defense, making that play, creating another third and long situation. Purple Hurricanes, that's your job. Go out, make this young quarterback, Ethan Lattimore, have to throw from third and 5+ and beat you.
So third down and 6. Hamilton, 5 carries, 41 yards, 32-yard touchdown run on their second snap of the game. Young man that's number 8 in 5A in rushing this season, number 1 in the region. Number 1 in the region, now has 16 total touchdowns on the season. Lattimore going to heave it downfield to an open man, incomplete. Wow, Hamilton was wide open and threw it behind him. Missed his target, and that was 6.
Just a wheel route out on the edge by Caden Hamilton, very capable of catching the ball out of the backfield. And just a miscue here by Ethan Lattimore here. Great play action fake. And you could see wide open, thinking he was going out on more of the pylon right there. Just throw it to the back of the end zone. And you have a touchdown if you're Lattimore.
Castaneda's 37-yard field goal attempt is a knuckleball right through the uprights. And it's 21-13. But trading field goals with touchdowns with Cartersville might keep you in the game, but it doesn't get you a victory. They're going to have to eventually put that ball in the end zone. They missed a great opportunity right there.
And what a weapon this young man, Oliver Castaneda, is for his team to be able to, in these conditions, pick a 47-yarder and 39-yarder offered by Memphis. Great weapon, as Coach Fominaya talked about, for his team. But you can't, as you're saying, Matt, trade field goals in this situation, especially the explosiveness that Carterville is showing offensively. Nate Russell with the miscue on that last drive for the interception. Chase Tyler, but he is showing you that he's growing up as well and giving them that ability to throw the ball deep.
Four plays, 4 yards on the drive, the Governor's red ribbon scoring drive. After the interception by Tyler, it set him up well, and they missed a golden opportunity to get 6 on the board. Cartersville's going to get it back. They have 2 timeouts remaining. Hiram has 3. And the kick from Castaneda will not be returned. That's about 67 yards in the air off the tee.
I guess his juice backed up. You know, the leg is back up for Castaneda. These two kickers, great kickers for high school level.
He was able to plug it in on the sideline while he was sitting over there. Got a juice back up, got the energy back in it. Georgia's shown some interest in Castaneda, by the way. Typically, the recruiting with kickers, that's kind of the last thing that comes. They wait to see what all happens, and sometimes kickers end up not getting scholarships right off the bat. They got to come there as a preferred walk-on and earn their way. Ball is out. Let's see who's got it. Hiram says they got it. At the 27-yard line, they're bouncing up and down, and they've got it. Cartersville with their second turnover on consecutive possessions, and Hiram has it back inside the 30.
And this is all on Christian Lando here, trying to make the cut up the middle of the field on Josiah Pope. Just have to be able to hold the ball in when you run between the tackles right there for the big senior running back. Gifting, once again, Hiram the short field. And with 1:12 to be able to punch something in and try to tie this game up or at least make it a one-point game.
I think you're right. It was Josiah Pope who stuck his arm in there and kind of punched it out as he was making the tackle. So the Hornets back on offense at the 28-yard line. And 72 seconds left in the half. Lattimore's in there at quarterback, going to pitch the ball to Kendarius Brown. He's had the hot legs tonight. Kendarius Brown dives forward for the first down. Brown has really impressed me tonight, the fullback there, who had 254 yards rushing for the season, had a big night so far here in the first half.
And Coach Fominaya, you threw me off about Kendarius Brown. You told me he was a power lifter, so I thought he was going to be more of a semi. He is definitely a race car out on the edge, number 4, with another big run.
Hamilton gets the handoff, and Hamilton knocked out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Yeah, Kendarius Brown, pound for pound, Coach Fominaya says he's the strongest kid he's ever coached. And he has had a big part in their ground game tonight, as has Caden Hamilton, which was expected as their leading rusher.
Good job executing on those first 2 runs, staying ahead of the sticks. That's what this offense needs to do. They have 3 timeouts so they can call anything they want.
Kendarius Brown up the middle this time, down inside the 10-yard line. They'll spot it right on the 10.
Hiram. That is their first charge timeout of the half.
So the Hornets have no need to panic here. They still have 2 timeouts. They have the ball at the 10-yard line. What they do have to concern themselves right now is the 3rd and 5 that's coming up.
And here's a play where Ethan Lattimore might have to use his feet to get down the field, make a play. We haven't really seen either quarterback pull the ball and run the ball for Hiram Great time maybe to pull the ball, but in these situations, look for that one-on-one matchup maybe with a Walter Matthews trying to get into the end zone.
Well, Coach Fominaya came up and talked to us. Of course, we spent an hour with him yesterday on Zoom and then came up to us here at the stadium tonight and said, when I moved here from Florida 6 years ago, we had an off night, and I saw the game on GPB, and I thought to myself, how cool would that be if Hiram could ever be on the Football Friday game of the week? And here they are tonight for the first time, and they've earned it. After going 2-19 between 20 and 21, those COVID years, they've turned it around. They're 11-6 since.
You can tell it mattered because he came and found us.
Yeah.
Typically, we go find the coach. He came and found us, and is so grateful for him and his team to be on TV tonight.
Third and five, right up the middle. That's a first down carry for Hamilton.
Great job for the little man there. Only listed at 165, but you could see the vision and those strong legs there running between the tackles, jumping for an extra 2 or 3 yards to set up this this first and goal.
That is their second charge timeout of the half.
So they can walk this thing on down, still have one timeout remaining, 31 seconds. And I think even if they get the touchdown here, they don't have to chase the points yet. There's going to be a lot more points scored in this game. So 31 seconds to go, and they've got it first and goal at the 4-yard line. And so far tonight, they've been able to survive the loss of their starting quarterback, Ryan Strickland. They're right in this game with the number one ranked Cartersville Purple Hurricanes.
And the thing we've seen on these last two drives is no penalties. They're not shooting themselves in the foot. They're not getting behind the sticks. They're able to make plays and stay on schedule when you run this kind of offense.
Well, they're used to big, hostile environments, and certainly Wineman Stadium would be considered one of those. Last year, they won at Calhoun. They've been in regions with Rome and Blessed Trinity. Now in the region with Cartersville and Calhoun, Dalton. Deshaun Williams. They're going to have to burn another timeout now.
Looks like they're going to try to get to the ball, maybe kill the clock. Not really sure. They're letting time click off. So they're just going to try to run a play here.
Well, they got to save the timeout for the field goal. They're going to go to the air. It's a jump ball, and it's caught by Chase Tyler. Did he get his feet down? He did. Touchdown. They're going to go for the one here.
Just how Chase Tyler would have drawn it up. Clock running down in the half, kind of scrambling around on offense high. Just throw me the ball. Keep it high. The young Ethan Lattimore here airing it out, throwing to the back of the end zone.
Time
50-50
out.
Ball here.
That is their
great
third and
job.
Final charge timeout of the half.
Great job there of knowing where he was on the field, tap dancing those toes for the touchdown.
Did a great job sticking the landing.
Yes, he did.
13th career touchdown catch for Chase Tyler.
See, just a 50-50 ball. My athlete is better than your athlete out in space. Jordan Woods, the young junior, doing everything he can. But when you have that big kind of frame there, gave yourself a chance to go up and get the ball, and then the work with the feet to stay in bounds. Spectacular there by Tyler.
Tyler committed to Duke. He was there the night the Blue Devils beat Clemson. He was there a couple of weeks ago when they had the dramatic game with Notre Dame. He's all in on his Duke Blue Devils commitment. He's a great basketball player, too. County Player of the Year in basketball, All-State in basketball. And there's been some talk that he's going to have a chance maybe to walk on that basketball team. Of course, football scholarship, and maybe get a shot at the basketball team, and that's a pretty big deal in Durham, North Carolina.
Yeah, I used to block a guy that did that. I mean, Julius Peppers. He was a basketball and DN.
Yeah.
What a big man he was. What a great player he was as well.
Interesting that they're going for the two right here. I think it's a little premature, but if they get it, it's great. And they've got the field spread about as wide as you can go. Right back in the middle and caught for the two. How about that? Walter Matthews, and Hiram has tied it up with 3 seconds left in the half.
Great look off by the young sophomore, Ethan Lattimore. Looked out to Caden Hamilton like he was going to run the screen out on the edge and then went back to Walter Matthews, the senior tight end. Great read there by the young quarterback.
So they'll... So the two-point conversion for Hiram, that's their fourth two-point conversion of the season. Your Governor's Red Ribbon campaign scoring drive, 6 plays, 28 yards after the fumble recovery. So the turnovers by the Purple Hurricanes have hurt them. It's cost them 10 points here in the second quarter.
And your two big players on offense.
Actually 11 points, pardon me.
Right there, Chase Tyler getting the touchdown. Walter Matthews getting the two-point conversion to tie this game up. Good throws there by the young sophomore. We wondered, could he throw the ball and step in for Ryan Strickland? On the last couple of drives, he's shown that he can.
So 3 seconds left in the half. Let's see if they squib it. Nope, just going to boom it. And so that means Carterville's going to get a chance to run a play. Was kind of surprised, thought they might squib it there and just try to burn the clock, but
it's juiced up now, man. It's juiced up. It's full power, so we're just going
to... It's glowing. It's glowing red.
Castaneda is just going to kick it off into the end zone.
So Cartersville will take over. Looks like they're going to go into a safety protection formation here and just take a knee and get to the locker room. But a big, big second quarter for Hiram here, capitalizing on turnovers after falling behind 14-10, then 21-10. And that's the end of the half.
Nice job of the offense responding to the defense on the turnovers, punching them in for scores to get their team, Hiram, back into this game.
So 21-21 as the teams head to the locker room, and a furious finish by the Hiram Hornets here late in the second quarter to knot up the score as the teams go to the locker room. A little bit of regrouping in store for Cartersville after they looked like they were in control of the game, hit some big plays, had an 11-point lead.
Had a bunch of big plays for offense. It's more about converting, and then finally Hiram settled down, stopped the penalties, and was able to get back in the game.
Tonight's coach's interview is brought to you by Johnny's New York Style Pizza, your original neighborhood pizzeria.
Thank you very much, Matt. Here with the coach. You took advantage of the turnovers. Initially it was threes, but then you get the big score here to finish up the second quarter.
Yeah, we really focus on the middle six. That's the 3 minutes to end the half and the 3 minutes to start the half. So these are critical moments for us. We believe they dictate the game. So we just won the middle three. We hope to come out in the second half and play well.
And at the same time, you're having to do it with a backup quarterback. I know you lost Ryan. He came back out. He had to exit again, but Lattimore's doing well for you.
He's a tough kid. You know, he's led our JV team all year. He's been part of one of the most winning classes that ever been at Hiram. So I know that young man will be okay.
Thanks for your time.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Halftime show coming up just around the corner, presented by our friends at Regions Bank. Hannah, who might be a little drier than the rest of us, will let you know what's going on around the state here on the great GPB Stick and Stay.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna Healthcare. Cigna Healthcare is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna Healthcare's mission is to improve the health and vitality of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink
of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Flu season, and with COVID rates on the rise again, millions of Americans are expected to get sick this season. How can you tell what's wrong if you're feeling sick? Patty Nuzzo, sales manager at Cigna Healthcare, is here to tell us how to recognize the signs and what to do when we feel sick. Patty, what can we do to help us prevent from getting sick?
Well, Hannah, the first thing you can do is get your flu shot and your COVID shot. Mm-hmm. Stay up to date. Get them. No excuses, especially if you're pregnant. Elderly folks and kids really need to stay up to date on their flu shots. Second thing is, don't share your food and drink. Just have your own food and drink. Third, wash your hands frequently. We should all be doing that by now. And then get plenty of rest.
How can you tell if you have a cold, flu, COVID, or something else, and what should you do to treat it?
It's a good question. Everybody's had a cold, runny nose, scratchy throat, watery eyes, sneezing, low-grade fever. You can't do anything for a cold. It's gonna run its course. You're gonna take some over-the-counter medicines and lots of fluid, get lots of rest. The flu, you're gonna feel it. You're gonna feel body aches. You're not gonna be able to get up out of bed. If you catch it within 48 hours, you can get an antibiotic, which may lessen the symptoms. And then the famous COVID. You should test for it if you feel like you have it, so you don't continue to spread it, but you're gonna feel very lethargic, tired, not being able to move.
Patty, thank you so much for being here. We hope everybody stays nice and healthy this flu season. For more information on this, please visit Cigna.com. Football Friday in Georgia halftime show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Hannah Gooden. We are live from Weinman Stadium for Hiram versus Cartersville, all tied up at 21. And John jinxed it before the break because it has chosen right now to start absolutely pouring down rain. There are five players between these two teams that are committed to D1 colleges, with eight plus more to make commitment soon. But what about the kids that get overlooked when it comes to recruiting? Here is this week's Make That Kid an Offer nominees. This week, we start with Sly County senior center and defensive tackle Wyatt Halstead. Last season, he was named the Region 6A First Team Offensive Line, awarded Lineman of the Year, and he's a champion wrestler and weightlifter. He's clearly a beast. Somebody make this kid an offer. Next up is Toombs County senior lineman Brock Nobles. The four-year starter functions as a tackle on both sides of the ball, and so far this year, he has 30 tackles with 5 sacks. He's also been awarded All-Region and All-State honors. Then we have Adairsville senior quarterback Jonathan Goff. Through 7 games this season, he's totaled 934 yards through the air with 10 touchdowns and 471 yards on the ground with 9 rushing TDs. He's earned multiple Player of the Game awards and All-Region QB and Coaches Leadership awards. And finally, it's Cartersville senior middle linebacker and tight end Connor Brasfield. On defense this year, he's notched 30 solo tackles, 9 tackles for loss, 3 sacks, 2 forced fumbles, and an interception. On offense, he's had 5 carries for 76 yards and 1 score. And Brasfield has put points on the board tonight. What can't he do? Coach Foster praised him before the game. Coach Foster also wanted to add senior safety and running back Richard Houston to that list. He said his first offer should be coming any day now, so make these kids an offer. Follow us on social media at GBB Sports to see how you can get your name on our Make That Kid an Offer segment next Friday. Okay, let's take a look around the rainy state on Georgia's EMC scoreboard. Georgia's EMC, so much more than electricity. The biggest matchup in 7A tonight, Buford versus Mill Creek. Buford up by a score 17-10. Then at Chris Gilman Stadium in Kingsland, Colquitt leading Camden County 16-7. Peach County finally begins region play tonight. Congratulations, that one is scoreless at the half. And a game that could already decide the region there. Pierce County up over Toombs County 7-0 in the first. Our second page of scores, we have Elbert County versus Rabun County. Right now, Elbert up by just a score, 7-0. Sly County leading Taylor County 14-6 in the second. Cedar Grove blanking Douglas right now 13-0. That game is in Region 5-3A. And on the other side of that region, it is our web game over at Tyrone, Carver Atlanta versus Sandy Creek, all tied up at 7. You can watch that one on gpb.org/sports or the GPB Sports app. We have to take a quick break, but coming up next, it is our You Save It Pharmacy Georgia Player Spotlight featuring a flag football star. Stay with us.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is all about Georgians standing together for substance misuse prevention. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Hi, I'm Josh Turner, Director of the Georgia Drivers Education Commission. Once teen drivers obtain their Class D license, additional restrictions still exist. For example, anyone with a Class D license may not drive between the hours of midnight and 5 a.m. During the first 6 months, only immediate family members can ride in the vehicle. During the second 6 months, only one passenger under 21 years of age and who is not immediate family can ride in the vehicle. And after 1 year, only three non-family members under 21 years of age can be passengers. These restrictions exist to protect young and inexperienced drivers by reducing distractions. In 2021, 54% of all traffic crashes involved at least one suspected or confirmed distracted driver, and 22% of all fatal crashes involved at least one speeding driver. The most important takeaway for teens is that driving is a serious responsibility that requires our complete attention. So buckle up, phone down, and drive safely, Georgia.
More 90s hits when we return.
Hey, look at that! Yo, lady, where's your seatbelt? Y'all, let's ditch this floor to be safe.
When you get into the car, you best not forget to pull that belt across your chest to hear it click. It's not that hard, it's simple to do. And every other passenger should wear one too.
You gotta wear, gotta bear to circumvent getting injured or worse in an accident. So put your seatbelt on without hesitation. Arrive safely to your destination.
Buckle up,
do the buckle up.
Everybody
gotta buckle up, do the buckle up.
Buckle up and get down.
Buckle up and get down.
If you're a high school student in the state of GA, sign up right now and make a PSA.
Everybody.
It's a rainy Friday the 13th here at Weinman Stadium. Hiram versus Cartersville. We're all tied at 21. It is time for our You Save It Pharmacy Georgia Player Spotlight. And this week we're talking about Southeast Bullock flag football standout Addie Hood. She's one of the reasons why they have two state championships and an undefeated program history. Here's her story.
I just read the quarterback. Whatever way you're going, I'll follow. I usually follow your eyes. They throw it, and then I just catch it.
She's diving after flags, laying out for balls, things like that. Our team gets excited, and they just feed off of her energy, and it helps us win games.
The first couple of games, people really didn't take us seriously until they started seeing us win.
We are lucky enough to have won two state championships here at Southeast Bullock and to do it undefeated.
3 years ago, I never would have thought that playing flag football would have led me to going to college.
The Yellow Jackets are 2-0 on the year, so look for Addie and Southeast Bullock to be back at the bins for the state championships this year. I don't want to jinx them, but they are so good. We have to take one more quick break, but coming up next, we have the Cartersville principal. We need to grab her an umbrella. See you in a second.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
The only in Cartersville, Bartow. Three Smithsonian-affiliated museums, Barnsley Resort, and an authentic downtown full of unique restaurants and shops. The perfect destination for a memorable staycation, only in Cartersville, Bartow.
Central Georgia EMC and 33 other participating Georgia Electric membership cooperatives congratulate Jackson High School on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events. Only one school in each region, in each classification, is chosen to receive this annual award. The GHSA takes into consideration all aspects of sportsmanship, making the award a tribute to the entire community.
Central Georgia EMC is so proud to present the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award to the Jackson Red Devils. This award is a testament to the players, the coaches, and the parents and onlookers for every game that they attend.
Introduced in 2006, this award reinforces the GHSA's philosophy that everyone associated with high school activities, from athletes to spectators, should adhere to the fundamental values it represents.
It's very honorable to be able to do that. Just to, you know, things we preach as coaches, you know, of being a good sportsmanship, you know, don't, you know, disrespect the game. And to be able to accept this award on behalf of all athletics just shows a testament to our athletes and the sportsmanship they've shown throughout the years, the different seasons, and being able to be a good athlete physically and, you know, mentally and emotionally.
Georgia EMCs and the 34 participating Georgia Electric membership cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to the Jackson High School community.
Welcome back. I'm here with Cartersville High School Principal Shelly Tierce, and I have to go on record and say we did offer you an umbrella. You did not want one. She is better than me. I am so impressed with the Cartersville community. It is raining. It is fall break. And your fans are out here in droves. What makes this community so special?
Well, I mean, obviously, we live in a great community. They love this school. They love our kids. And we have so many kids here active tonight. You know, obviously, we have our little dedicated student section. They're on fall break, and it's raining. We have our band, our football team, cheerleaders. We have our athletic trainers, you know, our audio video kids and our Canes Vision. They're running everything here. So we just a lot of student involvement that brings people out to support our kids.
If you guys have never been to a game here, the Canes Vision is amazing. The big screen, the replay is awesome. Yeah. Brag on your school a little bit. What's going on athletically, academically here?
Academically, our kids are working hard. Our kids always work hard. We hold them to a higher standard. Next week, we're lucky the softball team will be competing in the first round of the state playoff Monday. They won region last week, so come out and support those girls on Monday. And our volleyball team will be competing in the first round of the state tournament on Wednesday at home. So come out and support these student athletes. Those two girls' teams will have a big week ahead of us.
All right, Shelly, thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate you being here. John, where are you? Get over here. Okay, John, rainy day, rainy night around Georgia. How is that affecting the scores and what's on your mind? Do we need to share?
Well, we can't.
I'll hold this time. Well, I mean, honestly, it depends. South Georgia, you're still getting a lot of high scores on the board so far. You've got games in the 20s. Here, as you mentioned with Buford and Mill Creek, we've got games in the teens. So it will be interesting as the night goes on. Our resident meteorologist, the internet, said that this was supposed to be a 30% chance of rain. Here's your 100% chance of 30%. So, and I mean, with this surface being what it is, I mean, we've sampled, it's very slick, and we saw what it was like when the rain started first quarter. So very, very interesting to see how it plays out if these conditions continue. And those of us wearing hats and those of us who have umbrellas are wishing that it wouldn't, frankly.
Quick score update. Buford Mill Creek now tied at 17. And you've got about 15 seconds to give us a recap of the first half here.
Slippery, 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 and Hiram took advantage of Cartersville mistakes. We'll catch up with Connor Foster in a sec to get his perspective on things.
All right, go get him. Go get him. Oh, my gosh. We've lost control. Thanks for watching the Region's Halftime Show, everybody. More from this rainy Friday night at Wineman Stadium. Thank you so much for watching. This has been a great game. More from John, Matt, and Wayne right after this.
Riding down the road and you're doing just fine when a car in front of you crosses over the line. They're in your space, not looking at your face. Distracted drivers all over the place. Say,
we will, buckle up.
Sing it.
Say, we will, buckle up.
At TELUS Science Museum, the magic of discovery is larger than life. With tons of interactive exhibits and stunning visuals, come experience the magic of TELUS.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Back in Wineman Stadium, 21-21, as we get set for the start of the second half. And tonight's coach's interview is brought to you by Johnny's New York Style Pizza, your original neighborhood pizzeria.
Thank you very much, Matt, here with Connor Foster. And I know that a lot of the conversation had to do with the mistakes that led to the tie here in the second quarter. True?
Yeah, just settle back in. You know, it's the weather's crazy for both teams. It's been up and down first half for both teams. Just find a way to pull it out here.
And at the same time, I know that you're going up against an offense that is a unicorn out there. What was it like prepping on a short week to get ready for this offense that can come at you from a bunch of different angles?
I think we did a good job. You know, first half, I thought we played pretty good defensively. We got put in some tough positions, but obviously it's tough to get ready for what they do. It's tough to get a good look at their speed and all the different motions and shifts that they do. So I thought our kids have settled in pretty good. We'll see how we do in the second half.
All right, we'll keep you to it.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Go, Canes.
Yeah, it's Coach Foster, Matt. I think you've got things called highlights.
Indeed we do. So, Wayne, let's get right to him. And it was Hiram who jumped on the board first. Second snap of the game, 5 minutes into the game, and Hamilton goes 32 yards.
Right off the bat, the speedster out on the edge to put his team early up on the board.
Stayed that way until a minute was left in the first quarter, and Russell up top to Brassville, the tight end, to tie it up at 7. And then a couple of minutes later, it was Russell again going to the air.
Big time play here to Jamari Rice with the big play. Speed out on the edge for the touchdown, a guy that became a big player in that first half for his team.
Bryce, 55-yard touchdown reception, 14-7. Castaneda with the first of his two field goals. That from 47 yards made it 14-10. And then Christian Lando barrels up the middle.
Right up the middle for the big touchdown, the big running back, getting it going, showing the emotion for his team.
21-10 at that point. Castaneda came back and got a field goal after the interception by Tyler. And that made it 21-13. And then after a fumble with 3 seconds left in the half, Hiram cashes in on the jump ball by Tyler. And then they go for the two-point conversion to tie the game.
Getting it right there to Walter Matthews for the two-point conversion, tied the game, made it a game, took advantage of the turnovers, punching it in, and finally 21-21 at half.
What do the halftime stats tell you?
Right here, it was Hiram earlier with the penalties. Their 5 penalties really cost them points and cost them drives. That was a big key. And then the turnover for Cartersville. As you heard Coach Falkster talk about, both teams are playing in this wet condition, so you can't use that excuse. And both teams had big plays. Both teams had 4 plays, 20-yard-plus plays in the game. So it's an even game at half. Should be exciting here in the second.
Yeah, Hiram not able to throw the ball that well, although they got the 6 points on the jump ball throw by Ethan Lattimore. Needs to be repeated that Lattimore's now in there at quarterback, the sophomore backup, after Ryan Strickland twice got knocked out of the game. That second time probably has him out for the rest of the night. That's unfortunate for Hiram, but they have weathered the storm, so to speak, and tied up 21-21 as we start the third quarter. And the second half kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seat belts, save lives. And we're ready to get the second half started. Ryan Johnson has it teed up and ready to go. And we'll see if we have a kick return. So far tonight, have we had one or none?
I don't think we have one in that first. I don't think we have zero.
I think it's zero. Might have had one. We've had zero. Check it with Kevin Barnes, our statistician. He says zero. And it will stay that number as the ball goes to the back of the end zone. Ryan Johnson, who's committed to the University of Georgia, he's a right-handed pitcher. Throws a 91-mile-per-hour fastball for the state power Cartersville in baseball, and really has been a big find for them as a kicker, strong as a punter. 41-yard average, and Coach Connor Foster believes that if he wants to, he could possibly punt at the next level too.
Just a very great athlete is Johnson. Good size, big leg.
So Hornets back on offense, running that wing tee. You got that crisscross in the backfield. You get inside handoffs. You get sweeps. As you heard Connor Foster say, it's a very difficult offense to prepare for. But he felt like his defense did a pretty good job. Had it not been for the turnovers, we likely would not be tied 21-21 right now.
Early on, they were playing tight up to the line. They made an adjustment. After those couple of big plays to start the game, you see them playing a little more off with the linebackers so they can make those reads on who has the ball.
Handoff, Kendarius Brown right up the middle, crashes out to the 31-yard line, picks up the first down.
And this is what this Hiram offense, when they are playing clean football, and they stay ahead of the sticks right here. Brown once again running between the tackles, showing you that power. That's how they play. They just got to be patient and play clean football to try to take home this win.
He's their leading rusher tonight. He's now 7 carries, 75 yards. Pass is thrown to Walter Matthews. Walter Matthews, just an incredible physical specimen at 6'7", 245. Runs a 4.6 laser-timed 40. Lincoln Riley came out, watched him play basketball, sold him on his vision of how the Trojans would use him as a tight end in their offense. Double move, going to throw it short to Matthews instead. And Matthews has the first down out close to the 50.
Nice job there by Ethan Lattimore, the quarterback, going with the double pump. Didn't like what he saw going downfield. Decided to check it down to Matthews. As you said, Matt, as Coach Fomenaya said, with Matthews, feels like he's just a Sunday talent. One of those guys that, yes, this season for this offense, the numbers don't speak loud, but he just has that, all the tools to make it to Sunday playing football.
Kendarius Brown gets caught in the backfield, and that's Ollie Hamilton, the defensive end, with the TFL.
Nice job of penetration there by Hamilton. Only listed at 6 feet, 240, playing low, staying low, getting in the backfield. That's what you want to create. Get back to creating Purple Hurricane defense. Create those second and third and longs for this running offense.
Second down and 10. Now Matthews flexes out, top of your screen. Handoff goes to Sean Williams, has Kendarius Brown blocking for him, and Williams down to the 44-yard line. And that's one of the hallmarks, Wayne, of this wing T offense, is the running backs have to block for each other.
Everybody has to be on board to execute right here. It's Brown's chance to kick out right there. Running behind the pads is William, kind of the thunder to Caden Hamilton's lightning.
So what do we call Kendarius? He's the earthquake, right?
He is the quake. The hurricane of this offense. He is an all-around back, is Brown.
Seventh play of the drive coming up. It's third down and two. Kendarius Brown has the first down. And down to the 34-and-a-half-yard line. Nine-yard pickup for Kendarius Brown.
Good vision right there by the power back. Able to set his feet, cut to the outside, bounce it out, and pick up that first down.
He was a linebacker on this team. They converted him to fullback. You can tell it's been a good move for them. Nine carries, 84 yards. Kendarius Brown tonight. So first and 10, ball is put down on the 35. Hiram driving towards what they hope is the go-ahead touchdown here early in the third quarter. And I believe a timeout's going to be called by somebody.
We have the side referee fixing the chain.
That's what it is.
As they pulled the chain, looked like maybe the link came loose, and he's snapping it back on.
So the teams go to their sidelines to take this break in the action just to get a little word from their coach.
Good execution so far on this drive by Hiram. Clean football, something that they were not doing early on. Ever since those turnovers that they punched in to score, they've been playing clean football.
Initial timeout.
Hiram with an upset win tonight would throw the Region 7-5A race into a scramble. Right now, Cartersville's the only unbeaten team left in the region at 2-0. Calhoun is 1-1. Hiram is 1-1. I believe Dalton is also at 1-1. So that would lead it wide open. If Hiram was able to pull off the upset, it would leave it wide open here in this region for the final 3 weeks of the season. And this is maybe the deepest region in 5A, or maybe the entire state. You have five playoff caliber teams, and so somebody's going to get left out of the mix. Let's check in with John.
We always say that this is a multi-screen experience, rain or shine, here at GPB. So the web game is actually, they're moving along. Fourth quarter in AAA right now. Sandy Creek down at the battlefield in Tyrone. Carver Atlanta had a 7-0 lead. Sandy Creek has now scored twice. We are now at 8.5 and counting. And I'll go ahead and use the R word, Matt. Regulation. Sandy Creek leading Carver Atlanta 14-7 on the web. Brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management. Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football, back upstairs.
So the handoff goes to Deshaun Williams coming out of the officials' timeout. That's McBride who meets him in the backfield for the TFL.
Nice
second
job.
TFL for him tonight.
Nice job there by Luke McBride. We've seen him a couple of times where he just decides to use his instincts and go get the football. When you're doing all that multi-handoff look, it kind of freezes and kind of makes you soft as a linebacker, because you want to make sure you make the right read. That time, just shooting his gun, going in and getting that TFL.
McBride, a second-year starter at linebacker. And the pass gets batted down. That was Brassfield, the other linebacker, getting in there and wreaking some havoc.
Connor Brassfield, the heartbeat of this defense. The senior, 6'2", 220, coming off the edge this time. Just getting his hands up right there, that left hand. Trying to get the ball out there to his big target, Walter Matthews. Nice read of the quarterback eyes to knock that down.
Yeah, saw him down on the sideline prior to the game. He's built like a tree trunk. Third down and 12. Lattimore scrambles to the outside. He might be in trouble out there, and he is. He goes down at the 39. I think friendly fire got knocked down by one of his offensive linemen.
Trying to keep his head down the field. To get the ball out late there, maybe to Caden Hamilton. Just couldn't navigate the traffic in front of him, slipping on the turf on his lineman there. And hats off to Cartersville and his defense, creating another third and long situation. It's this offense, as we continue to say, the Hornets is really not built to be in third and 12.
This is a 58-yard field goal attempt. Holy smokes, Castaneda trying to make some history, and Connor Foster calls a timeout.
Cartersville, that is their first charge timeout of the half.
So we'll step aside and come back and see if Castaneda will indeed try a 58-yard field goal attempt.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day living in the right space. Breathing your face got me feeling so kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Coming out of the timeout, Castaneda, they're still lining up for what would be a 58-yard field goal. Cartersville, you believe, had 12 men on the field. That's why they called the timeout?
Yeah, I think that's what Coach supposed to call the timeout. It still wouldn't have gave Hiram a first down, but it gave him a free 5 yards.
This is for 58 yards. Kick is on its way, and the kick is no good. Just a little bit short. It was on target. And we have an offensive lineman who's down on his back at the 43-yard line, but Castaneda just missed a 58-yard field goal here in the rain. Here's a good look at it from the end zone.
Had it lined up. It just came up short right
there. My goodness.
About 57 yards he had on it, just missing by a yard. And this is in the rain.
It's on a slick turf.
When you think about it, on a slick turf.
Young man, Coles, five-star. He is a legitimately five-star rated kicker. You've seen what he's been able to do on kickoffs. He's already hit two field goals tonight and just missed a 58-yard attempt. Now, the good thing about this in Georgia high school football is there's no penalty for trying it, because the ball comes out to the 20. It isn't the line of scrimmage or the spot where the kick is made like it is in the NFL. It's like a punt. So Cartersville takes over at the 20. If you've got a kid that can do it, it's a good play. It's a good roll of the dice. Right up the middle, Christian Lando carrying the safety. And Lando still moving forward, takes three guys to get him on the ground. What a tough run by Christian Lando as he goes up the middle for 22.
Great job in the middle of that line right there. Jaden Curtis, Luke Surrett, Medina just running quickly. Once again, we saw him earlier score a touchdown, just running up on the safety, Anthony Pittman, before he can barely react for the big game.
So first and 10 for Cartersville as they push it out to the 42 on the very first snap of this possession. Lando again running hard, getting a little bit of that Philadelphia Eagles tush push right there. Gets an extra yard or two.
Until they banned it, keep using it. Nice job running behind his pads. Didn't feel like he could get to the outside and just went to driving those legs.
Now, you can't do it in high school football. You can't get behind the guy and push him. But you can push the pile. You can get in there and kind of move the pile, kind of like an elephant pushing a boulder. And Lando gets tripped up. I think he actually ran into Brassfield as tight end. And it's going to be third down.
Nice job, Jason Guybe, of hitting Connor Brassfield and kind of shortening that hole. You can see 26 and 44 right there. Guybe having enough pop on that hit to push Brassfield back into Lando.
Lando, 9 carries, 82 yards tonight. And a third down and 5 coming up with the ball sitting on the Cartersville 47-yard line. Going to run it again, Houston. Houston not going anywhere. Guybe gets the TFL.
Big penetration by Petway and Garland, 97 and 90 here on your screen. In the backfield, making Houston having to bounce it, and then Guybe coming to clean up there for the Hornets.
Fourth down. Let's see what Cartersville's going to do here. They're going to bring the punt unit on. I think that's the smart play. You're in a tight game. You don't want to give the ball up to Hiram in a short field. So Chase Tyler going to go stand at the 15-yard line and await this kick from Ryan Johnson. No rush. Going to try to set up a return. Tyler calls fair catch. Makes it on one knee at the 18-yard line. 35-yard kick by Ryan Johnson. And Hiram, as you see, the rain is picking up. You can really start to see it's a driving rain now. Started out as kind of a mist, and it's just gotten heavier as the night's gone on.
Very slick out on the field. Both teams finding themselves in third. 5+ there on those opening drives, but they're very capable with the running backs they have to take over this game. Either one of these run teams, especially with the offensive lines that they have.
As an offensive lineman, you like this weather.
Yeah, this is the kind of weather
this is
that
perfect.
You hope for.
As an offensive lineman, you just love the slop. Hamilton fighting for yardage. Brassfield wrestling with them. Man, both of these teams and their running backs have been hard to get on the ground. 8-yard pickup.
Nice here job by Hamilton. Getting up in that lane right there, just driving those legs. Only 165, but Coach Fomenaya talked about how strong he is after contact. 7 yards on that first run right there to start this drive.
Deshaun Williams, great block by Kendarius Brown on the edge, just springing forward for 3 yards to pick up the first down. Watch the replay on this. This is quintessential wing T offense. And number 4, Kendarius Brown, the fullback. Watch his block on the play.
Right here with the kickout block on Christian Lando to spring his running mate Williams free to pick up that first down. And to run this scheme, as we have talked about, the backs have to be a unit that are willing to sacrifice themselves and block.
Up the middle, Kendarius Brown gets fed the ball. Race to the end zone. Brown trying to beat his man, and Bryce runs him down at the 16-yard line, but a huge gain for Kendarius Brown.
A little mix-up there by Ethan Lattimore on this handoff. The ball almost slipped on the ground, and then the man of the day, KB, once again, out in the open field for the big run.
That is a 53-yard gain. Handoff goes to Watley. Jamarian Watley trying to clear the edge. And Watley takes a double hit and goes down at the 14-yard line after picking up a couple of yards. And there is a flag down as well.
Going to get a personal foul here, most likely.
Holding on the offense.
Jamison Riggs.
That penalty will be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Replay, first down.
That's a killer.
Jamison Riggs, the left tackle, working his way across the field, a three-star Georgia Tech commit.
Wants to be an aerospace engineer.
And it's an aerospace building right there here right. at Cartersville, which lines up perfect, but a smart young man who's picked Georgia Tech, especially for their engineering department, and his coach feels like he's the best lineman in the state of Georgia.
Well, Coach Fomaniah said, look, you know, when he heard that Riggs wanted to be an aerospace engineer, he said, Jamison, you're too big to get in a rocket. He goes, I don't want to get in a rocket. I just want to build them.
6'5", 290 senior.
Handoff goes to Hamilton. Hamilton, first down and more. Inside the 10, Hiram has the lead.
The speedster, Caden Hamilton, so dangerous out in the open field. Kelson Mitchell, number 15, up the field. You could see Martavius Cochran as well. Both had a shot at his legs, but the speed of this young man to get to the edge for the touchdown.
First lead for Hiram since their touchdown by Hamilton way back in the first quarter. Castaneda, they get it down. Tyler is also the holder. He did a good job of getting that ball upright for his kicker to put it through, and it's a 28-21 lead for Hiram here at Wineman Stadium. What a night for these running backs for the Hornets.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is all about Georgians standing together for substance misuse prevention. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business so business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Welcome back to Wineman Stadium, 3:18 for the third. Hiram now with the lead. Let's go to the multi-screen experience, and it is another tight one. 3:18 in the third left here. 3:49 to go, regulation with Sandy Creek and Tyrone. Carver Atlanta now has the lead in the back and forth. Once again, this is a region that does not surprise when it comes to tight scores and games that go back and forth. Go to gpb.org/sports, the GPB Sports app. Wiley Ballard on the bark with us. Those games all season long brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management. Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football, and also maybe plastic bags to watch the games back upstairs.
All right, thank you, Nelly. 17 straight points, actually 18 straight points for Hiram. They were down 21-10 with under 4 minutes to play in the first half. They've scored the last 18 points to take a 7-point lead here now. 3 minutes left in the third quarter, and a non-returnable kick again by Castaneda, and the ball comes out to the 24 Cartersville, and they're playing from behind for the first time since the first quarter.
And this is being done with their sophomore replacement quarterback, Ethan Lattimore, for Hiram, and the rush game finally coming along. Now can this Purple Hurricane offense who, when it had success in the first half, it really was explosive plays. Can they get back to driving the ball, making plays? Nate Russell working the ball down the field, trying to find Jamari Bryce.
Well, Coach Fomenaya said they had a different week of practice this week. He saw that the switch had been flipped after their disappointing loss to Calhoun at home last Friday night. Ball goes to Brassfield. Third catch of the game for the big tight end, and he rumbles out to the 34-yard line and a first down for Cartersville.
Nice job of Brassfield out in the flat. We saw this a couple of times in the first half. Just working off the edge. Typically in those situations, they're running the ball. He's kicking that in out, just slipping out in the flat for a big gain.
So first and 10, 14-yard pickup for Brassfield. Three catches for 33 yards for the senior. Up the middle, Lando! Nobody catching him. Second big touchdown run of the night for Christian Lando. 66 yards, and Cartersville back to within a point.
Once again, outstanding job in the middle of this offensive line. No one touches Christian Lando. He would have been a touchdown in a flag football game right there. Young man bursting through the middle. And when you come through that clean, can't say that enough, it's hard on your safeties. They don't have time to react. Willie Brown, Anthony Pittman have no time to react when the running back comes at them at that kind of speed.
Ryan Johnson, they get it up and in, and we're tied at 28. Cartersville behind in this game for all of 35 seconds before they tie it right back up again.
Just right here. No one touches him as he comes through the hole. As you can see, as Willie Brown is trying to get down to make the play, just a blast of speed there by Christian Lando for the big touchdown.
And Wayne, that is an offensive line with Luke Surrett, Richmond commit at center. Left tackle, Langston Hogg. He's got six offers already. He's just a sophomore. Been offered by Vandy in Oregon. He's going to be at Vandy tomorrow for the Georgia game. Malachi Tolliver, of course, the right tackle, who we highlighted off the top. Probably a four-star interior offensive lineman. All the recruiting surfaces having a tackle. He's going to Georgia.
And number 56, the senior Jaden Curtis, watching him tonight. The way he moves out there, very athletic for that size at 280, but talented offensive line, great conditions, as you alluded to, Matt, to break out your offensive line and your running backs. It's wet, it's rainy, got a little mist in the air. These running backs are shining here in the second half.
So now Ryan Johnson. Another booming kick. And these kickers have not relented. They've not given one inch. Every kick has been either into the end zone or all the way through the end zone in the air.
And we have to be approaching some kind of record. No kickoff return yards. Has to be in high school, zero in this game.
Yeah, and we've had, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. By my count, we've had 11 kickoffs and not one return yard. Amazing. Handoff goes Kendarius Brown. He's back in business. Switches hands, cuts to the inside. Cuts to the inside sideline and another huge gain. 53 yards for Kendarius Brown.
Kendarius Brown, the senior. His coach said he was a dirty, working type lunch pail. Where did you come up with this speed, Mr. Brown?
He's got 190 yards rushing, Wayne.
Just big play after big play from the power lifter right there. What a game he's having.
Amazing performance by Kendarius Brown tonight. He had 254 in the first seven games of the season. He's gone for 190 tonight. Playing some inspired football. And first carry of the night for the backup fullback, Amari Lindley. That's the first carry for him tonight as Kendarius Brown apparently finally got tired. He's been running up and down the field all night.
Another big body in there at fullback for for Lively right there. 5'9", 185, running behind his pads. Physical ending to that run.
Handoff, Watley. Jamarian Watley getting pulled apart right there by the defenders. Best get on the back ground the best you can if you can, because they're about to rip him in two.
Nice job of Richard Houston there, number 22, making sure this play has to be cut back to the inside, making the fullback miss on the block. And this is the down and distance. If you're going to have success of stopping Hiram, Cartersville got to get off the field when it's third and five plus against the Hornets.
So Watley, who's number two on the depth chart, Lindley, who's number two on the depth chart, got those guys in the game here late in the third quarter trying to rest up their guys for the fourth. Hamilton still in there, though, and Hamilton crashes down close to the 20, and a flag comes out. We're going to have some kind of personal foul and sportsmanlike penalty in all likelihood coming up here.
Looked like it might be a late hit in the back. Clem Richard, 65, the three-star, headed to Wake Forest. Looks like maybe he showing signs of that frustration body language. Not agreeing with the call. Let's see what they have here.
Well, it's fourth down and two, pending the call on the field.
After the play, personal foul on the offense. That penalty is 15 yards, fourth down.
That's an absolute killer right there, because that turns it into fourth and two. Possibly you're going for it. Now you're going to try another long field goal here by Castaneda. This is going to be a 51-yard attempt, it looks like.
You definitely feel like Coach Fumagalli was going to go for it.
Yeah.
The momentum they've had running the ball in this situation to try to put seven on the board, or at least get the first down to give his team a chance, now going for the field goal.
51-yard attempt. Straight on look at it right there. And this one's going to be off the mark, I think, unless it comes back. It won't. Had the distance, but it was off the mark. And so the score remains tied at 28. And you can see Fomania right there. He's got some words for his offensive line after they cost him a lot of yardage with a fourth and two coming up and had to settle for a long field goal attempt that was wide to the left.
And that's been their Achilles heel tonight. And they've had big plays. They've had a penalty that took it back. And in this situation, in this game, as the quarter going down, that would have been a big fourth and two to possibly get a first down, keep that drive going. Cartersville, their defense, getting a little momentum. And now the explosiveness of Christian Lando back on the field, the running back, after that last drive with the 66-yard run.
They're going to hand off to Lando again in another gaping hole for Christian Lando, who's running through the Hiram defense. That's a first down. Willie Brown got him on the ground, but that's an 11-yard pickup.
No jet sweep, no trickery with the ball, just handing it off, going downhill right here. Good blocking right there. Langston Hogg, the left tackle, and Medina, the left guard there, following his blocking is Christian Lando for another first down.
And you got to admit, 73, Langston Hogg, he's a sophomore. I mean, he was destined to be an offensive lineman from birth, right? With the last name Hogg. Lando again. Willie Brown again making the tackle. That's 8 yards downfield. That was probably the final play of the third quarter. Cartersville has right up approaching 185 on the ground, and most all of it, about 95% of it, has come from Lando. He's got 168 on the ground as we've reached the end of the third quarter. And the LED light heading to the fourth quarter celebration lights up the stadium. 28-28 as we head to the fourth.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
Cigna Healthcare is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna Healthcare's mission is to improve the health and vitality of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
just read the quarterback. Whatever way you're going, I'll follow. I usually follow your eyes. They throw it, and then I just catch it.
She's diving after flags, laying out for balls, things like that. Our team gets excited, and they just feed off of her energy, and it helps us win games.
The first couple of games, people really didn't take us seriously until they started seeing us win.
We are lucky enough to have won 2 state championships here at Southeast Bullock and to do it undefeated.
3 years ago, I never would have thought that playing flag football would have led me to going to college.
Buckle up, Georgia, and you buckle up at home as we head to the fourth quarter here in a tie game as the ninth-ranked Hiram Hornets trying to knock off the number one-ranked Cartersville Purple Hurricanes for the first time ever. And we're tied at 28 as we head to the final 12 minutes. Matt Stewart, Wayne Gandy, John Nelson, Hannah Gooden, what has been a driving rain the entire night. And second down and 2 coming up for Cartersville as we start the fourth period, and they have the ball at their own 41-yard line. Christian Lando's been the big story. 12 carries, 168, and a couple of big, long touchdown runs. Going to get it again. Instead, this time it's going to be Richard Houston on the carry.
False start.
And there is
a
flag
down. That penalty is 5 yards. Replay. Second down.
Malachi Tolliver, the right tackle, just going a little early right there, trying to get into that double team block. Got to sit in there, big fella. Coach Stacy Searle up there at UGA. Going to have some laps for you. You do that up there for the Georgia Bulldogs.
Second down and 7 now. Ball back at the 36 following the penalty. And Houston going to get it again. And Houston, another flag goes down on the play. Anthony Pittman coming up from the safety spot to help out on that tackle, but check the call.
We get a holding here on Brassfield, 44.
Holding on the offense. That penalty is 10 yards from the previous spot. Still second down.
So a couple of back-to-back penalties by Cartersville. A little bit of a shaky start to this fourth quarter for him. There's the hold right there by Brassfield.
Got to drive those feet and those feet right there in that situation on Josiah Pope. Once you see he's secured that outside, just start pushing on him and let the running back navigate you in that situation, Mr. Brassfield.
Second and 18. Nate Russell, the quarterback. 8 of 13, 165. Couple of touchdown passes. Also thrown an interception tonight. But by and large, both these teams have relied on their running game this evening in the wet rain. Streaking open, Bryce, oh, cannot come up with it. Jamari Bryce got separation, Wayne, but couldn't come up with it.
And this is just a flat-out go route here on Anthony Pittman, who was peeking in the backfield, kind of left Bryce alone, airing it out. Ball is on target. And just not able to come up with it right there is Jamari Rice.
You know, you just could not ask for a better ball from Russell right there. It was spot on, tight spiral, and Bryce just could not come up with it. Third down and 18. Again, passing, hit as he throws, intercepted! Or did he? I think they dropped it. 3 guys hit it. Russell got drilled as he let go of the ball and had to short arm it a little bit.
2 chances on the back end here. I want to say Willie Brown, number 11, had a chance here. Pressure in his face. Malachi Tolliver getting pushed back into Nate Russell. Wobbly ball. Fighting for it right there. The 2 safeties, Brown and Pittman, just not able to come up with it.
And so Ryan Johnson on the punt. Stands at his 11-yard line. Chase Tyler deep. Number 1 in the region in punt return yardage. High snap, and he gets it out of there, but it's a short kick, or shorter than usual, I should say. But then they get a nice bounce at the end of it, and it spins out of bounds at the 36, a 38-yard kick. Hiram going back on offense when we get back in a tie game and 11 to go.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Riding down the road and you're doing just fine when a car in front of you crosses over the line. They're in your space, not looking at your face. Distracted drivers all over the place. Say,
we will buckle up.
Sing it.
Say, we will buckle up.
Fifty-two seconds gone here in the fourth quarter. Quickly, let's go to the web game, gpb.org/sports. It was a 4th and 10 for Carver at their own 32, and it looks like they've got a pass interference call or a personal foul. They've got a new lease on life. 1:15 to go, regulation, down 5. They've got a score. They score. They win, Matt. 20-15, gpb.org all season long. Brought to us by our friends at Brady Pest Management. Brady Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football. We'll trade. I can trade spots with you if you want for the rest of the game.
Yeah, that's all right. You're doing great down there. Both of our games going down to the wire tonight. It's 28-28 here at Weinman Stadium. And nothing doing. Cartersville defense rallies to the ball. Big Keelan McCarthy, the bowling ball nose guard, leading the way on the tackle. Second down and 9 coming up. Look at the numbers for Kendarius Brown tonight. Nearly as many yards rushing tonight, Wayne, as he had the entire season coming in.
An explosive night for him running the ball. You come in, you look at his numbers, you think more, he's going to do more blocking. And tonight he has been unleashed as the primary runner, making some big runs, been very effective running between the tackles.
Handoff inside goes to Hamilton. Hamilton surging forward across the 40 down to the 42 and still moving his feet. And that pile is still moving. It's like a rugby scrum to get the first down.
Nice job of his team rallying to him right here. A lot of misdirection on this play right there. Couldn't figure out who had the ball. Finally, Luke McBride is able to grab Hamilton. And then the tug of war rugby match starts of who can stay low and who can drive those legs to pick up another first down.
Saw big 50 Christian Dudley, the left guard, a heavyweight wrestler in the Hiram program. He was just moving the pile by himself. He just got behind him and started pushing everybody. First and 10, going to the air. And it's going to be a jump ball situation, and Tyler cannot come up with it, but we're going to have a flag on the play, as I believe Jordan Woods is going to be whistled for the DPI.
Fighting all the way down the field, hand fighting Chase Tyler. Jordan Woods here, you can see play action fake. Nice pickup there by Kadarius Brown on the linebacker, and then it just becomes about pushing and shoving. And just
pass interference on the defense. That penalty is 15 yards, resulting in a first down.
Well, I don't know if the contact came as the ball got there, unless there was contact before that. But the officials certainly thought they saw some there, and it's going to be first and 10 at the 38 for Hiram as they've moved the ball across midfield and now in Cartersville territory with 9:47 to play in regulation. Ethan Lattimore, the sophomore quarterback, in for the starter, Ryan Strickland, who got knocked out. Handoff goes to Hamilton, goes to the far side. Either slips or got tripped up trying to make the cut down the sideline. It's going to be third down.
Nice job once again getting to the edge. You can see the frustration. He knew he had something big here. If he could have kept his feet, just slipping over his offensive lineman, Torian Edge, his feet right there as he tried to cut up the field.
So second down and eight. Hamilton's had a big night too. He would be the guy that we expected to have the biggest night, 11 carries, 92 yards for him. But Kendarius Brown has nearly doubled up his yardage total tonight. Lattimore going up top again, a jump ball and incomplete. And they were trying to get Deshaun Williams, who came out of the backfield, and it's going to be third down.
Just running a wheel route down the sideline there, just airing it out, trying to catch the defense sleeping, making a read on Matthews and Tyler, hoping they get lost down the field there, the Williams. When you're running the ball as successfully as they have, they have to take some shots down the field to keep the defense honest.
And you wonder about Brown and his big night tonight. Remember, Coach Foman, I said, look, our offense is predicated on what the defense gives us. So they maybe were given something there and opening things up for Kendarius Brown. But this time, nothing available as the linebacker, Kelson Mitchell, is there to lead the tackling along with big Keelan McCarthy, and it's going to be fourth down, and let's see what they do here. They've tried two 50-plus field goals so far tonight.
Nice job just staying home right there. McCarthy, big number 39. You see Jordan Woods coming up as well on that play. Big decision here. We've seen him try long field goals. You see Castaneda over there kind of warming up.
This would be, what, about a 54-yarder in somewhere in that range if they kick.
After the play, personal foul on the offense. That penalty will be 15 yards, fourth down.
Well, there won't be any field goal attempt now. It's going to be a punt.
Big miscues by both teams with penalties in this game. A lot of positivity on both sides has been negated tonight with penalties, and here where you might have had an idea of kicking a field goal, now you end up punting and giving them more field position.
Castaneda on the punt. Line drive kick, spiraling downfield, hit at the 20, now bounces inside the 10 and rolling dead at the 1. Oh my goodness, a 51-yard punt by Oliver Castaneda. And that nails Cartersville down at the 1-yard line, 99 yards away from the end zone. When we come back with 8:31 remaining in regulation.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMCs support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is all about Georgians standing together for substance misuse prevention. Be kind to your mind. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Back at Weinman Stadium, Matt Stewart, Wayne Gandy, John Nelson, Hannah Gooden on a rainy night. Cartersville's won 68 of their last 69 region games dating back to 2011. This would be a huge upset for a Hiram program that's just locked down their seventh winning season all time with their sixth victory a couple of weeks ago out of their own end zone, snapping the ball. And did he get back to the one? He did. Very dangerous right there. Run by Lando, who's had a huge night. Got stonewalled at the one.
Offensive line got a cut down there, splits. You kind of approach this like trying to go in. You were on the 1 yard line trying to score. You got to cut down your splits, stay tight. Running backs, quarterbacks, anyone involved with the ball has to make quick decisions. One cut and start running upfield. You're just trying to get 2 or 3 yards for your punter. That's your first mission, creating punt room for your punter.
Russell's going to throw out of his own end zone, and it's incomplete at the 10-yard line. And it's going to be third down and 10 from the one.
Play action fake, trying to get the ball over to Bryce. Coming up short, Bryce trying to work back to the ball. Good coverage there.
Are you a little surprised they passed out of their own end zone there?
I'm very surprised on that play, especially the way that they can run the ball with Christian Lando. You imagine that they were going to run those first two plays.
Because now you almost all have to pass out of the end zone now, right? They're going to go to the air again. Going to go deep. And it is intercepted. Intercepted at the 38-yard line. Brandon Davis, the cornerback, with his first interception of the season.
Jamari Bryce, triple covered over here. You see three jerseys working their way to Bryce. Just quarterback and receiver not on the same page there. Looks like Nate Russell was expecting more of a down the field route. Bryce was working back to the ball. Big interception there by Brandon Davis, not giving up on the play and going to get that interception.
So the ball goes over on downs as Hiram has it at the 38-yard line. Handoff goes to Hamilton, and bobbling the ball as he goes out of bounds at the 32-yard line is able to retain possession. We're going to send you to a double box now, which means we're going to be here at this game and also checking out Carver and Sandy Creek. Final play of the game and a chance to win it for the Patriots and a jump ball in the end zone. And it's going to be incomplete as the clock hits zero. And it looks like Carver was going for the final touchdown right there. And that looks like that's the end of the game. Sandy Creek has held on for a 20-15 victory. Now back to live action here. And a first down carry, it appears, for Hiram. So it looks like Sandy Creek avoids the home loss and holds off Carver Atlanta on the final play of the game.
Nice job working on that right side. Two plays in a row. We do have a player down for Hiram.
That's Travion Thomas, their center. So Hiram now has two running backs that have gone north of 100 yards rushing tonight. Hamilton, 13 carries for 102. 191 for Kendarius Brown. So those two backs alone are approaching 300 yards of rushing against this Cartersville defense. That was giving up just 90 yards rushing per game.
The Hornets offense came in averaging almost 278 yards a game rushing. Most of that had been Hamilton and Williams. But Kadarius Brown getting in the action tonight. Yep.
While they tend to Travion Thomas over there, we'll step aside with 7:24 to play.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
So they're able to help the starting center, Travion Thomas, off the field in a big third and one coming up. Let's see who they put in there to snap the ball.
Looks like they have Quentin Kelso, number 57, in there at center.
And a big third down right here, third and one. Handoff goes to Williams, Deshaun Williams, gonna get the first down. Down to the 25-yard line. We have three 100-yard rushers in this game tonight. This is just old-school football.
Nice job there by Deshaun Williams. He felt that backside pursuit, wanted to make sure he got that first down. He took the first hole that he could find, got those shoulders square, drove those legs, and picked up that first down for his team.
Handoff goes to Hamilton. Slices through a couple of defenders, and then McBride going to make the tackle after about a yard or two-yard gain. Great pursuit by Luke McBride on the play to cut down what looked like had a chance to be a big play.
Big penetration, pushing this play to the outside. So slippery is Caden Hamilton right there. As you can see, Reed Azale missing the tackle. Slicing underneath Cole Crawford as well. Only a two-yard gain, but it started off looking like it was going to be a three-yard loss.
Lattimore going to the end zone in a jump ball, and it is caught over the shoulder, and that is going to be a touchdown. 23-yard touchdown catch by Chase Tyler, and it's 34-28.
Once again, as we spoke about, not a lot of catches, but the catches are big for the four-star Duke commit. Once again, working on Jordan Woods out on the edge, a 50-50 ball in this situation with his kind of talent. It's just something you're going to really take him 80% of the time in a one-on-one matchup.
Castaneda, the PAT, hit the upright. It's no good. Wow, what a turn of events right there. Castaneda, who's done just about everything right tonight, looked like the snap was okay, wasn't it?
Look, it looked like it hit the turf and bounced up into Chase Tyler's hand, who was still able to set it.
But that bounce is enough just to throw off the timing enough, and it's 34-28. Here's another look at that 23-yard touchdown pass from Lattimore. And Tyler just beat his man and sticks the landing again. He just does so super job. You can see why he's rated as high as a four-star and number 13 wide receiver in the country. Duke getting a good one. Duke's doing a great job of recruiting. We saw Montez Smith, the linebacker for Carrollton last week. He's a Duke commit.
Ethan Lattimore. The young sophomore, trust me, he's in love with the talent of a Chase Tyler. We could just throw it up to the big fella for touchdowns like that. Their second connection for touchdowns tonight.
Castaneda. This is going to be returnable from inside the 5-yard line. Our first return kick of the night, right up the middle, and like a streak of lightning, great return by number two, Adarian Taylor Wilson, but there are flags down. That was a 32-yard return on the first return of the night for either team.
You have to wonder, missing that PAT, is that was in Castaneda's head right there.
Holding on the return team. That penalty 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
So let's see where the holding occurred. That's going to be critical as to where this ball is going to be put down. And it looks like it's going to be the 23. So the holding must have happened near the point of the tackle.
Right at the point of it. Which is unusual for it to be that far up by the ball.
Yeah.
And only get a 37-yard return.
So the ball's at the 23, first and 10 for Cartersville. They're down six. And Lando trying to bull his way through that offensive line and through the defensive line. Doesn't get very far. Clinton Richard, the Wake Forest commit on the offensive line, playing on the defensive line here late in the game.
Big game late in the season. All athletes are on your chalkboard now. That's everybody's right in the game. When you talk about this kind of competition in this region,
there is no depth chart.
Yes.
You're getting in the game. Russell dumps it off here for Bryce. Jamari Bryce trying to cut back across the grain. Still on his feet and dropped at the 38. Does pick up the first down. A lot of running there by Jamari Bryce to get 11 yards.
One cut too many. Cut over into Chase Tyler. Couldn't get to the outside, but what great vision that this young man Bryce has right there. Look at this ability, seeing the field, the balance. Just couldn't get outside of Tyler for maybe a touchdown there. Nice job of Tyler being able to bring him down with that long frame.
Third straight game for Cartersville that looks like it's headed to the final minute or final play of the game. Bryce, four catches, 98 yards tonight. Lando gets the rock. Tried to cut through the gap and gets tackled on the play by Guybee.
Guybee and Pittman on that play right there. Good job of Isaiah Swando coming up the field, making Lando cut that ball back inside.
Second down and eight. We're under five to go now. And the Purple Hurricanes are down a touchdown. Houston gets the handoff, follows his blocker through the hole. Houston cuts up and runs down to the 43.
Great blocking up front. Good blocking there by Brasfield. Better vision there by Richard Houston here to bounce this to the outside, making Anthony Pittman miss right there with that cut. Both teams impressive with these running backs tonight.
Now under 4 minutes to go. That was a 17-yard pickup for Houston. He's going to get it again right up the middle. Houston right through the defense and down to the 17.
Nice job once again running behind his pads. A physical runner in Houston, 5'10", 195 senior. Just coming downhill, similar to Christian Lando, coming at the safety so fast, it's just hard for the safety to react. In those situations, good blocking in the middle of that line again.
25-yard pickup, back-to-back carries, 42 yards for Houston to get him down inside the 20. And this is right out of the playbook for Cartersville. This is what they love to do. They like to get behind that offensive line and give it to their power running backs in the fourth quarter. Houston breaks through a couple of tackles and down to the 5-yard line. Malcolm Garland, the defensive tackle, had him wrapped up and he burst right through his arms.
Houston with the vision here. Jaden Curtis, the right guard, pulling. Houston seeing it's a backside cut. Running behind the pads, getting out of that tackle of Garland to pick up another 8 or 9 yards. Tough running for that young man right there. Stepping in, Christian Lando was doing most of the work for the first 3.5 quarters. This young man trying to take it home.
Under 3 minutes to play now. Houston 7 carries, 61 yards. Most of it on this carry and on this drive. And Houston down to the 2-yard line on his next carry.
I think you're going to get Hiram calling a timeout, trying to save some
time. Hiram. That is their first charge timeout of the half.
Yeah, Cartersville's in a situation right here. Houston is face down on the wet turf right now. Cartersville's in a situation right here where they can kind of slow walk this thing and burn clock. Clock is stopped at 2:31. Houston, four carries, 56 yards on this drive alone.
Just a physical downhill run here between the tackles, shoulder swear, legs driving, and maybe right there at the end, as you can see at his feet there, Jason Guybe has his legs. Maybe that ankle got twisted at the end.
Let's check in with John. He's got some score updates for us.
Got some finals trickling in from around the state with some partials late as well. Carver-Columbus knocks off Crisp tonight 24-7. Big matchup down in South Georgia. Pierce County over Toombs 17-14. That region is officially in the blender with Pierce, Toombs, and Appling. Lowndes leading Dunbar of Florida late 17-7. Colquitt County in Region 1-7A knocks off Camden County after trailing early 37-16. In single A, Sly County, they were in a fight early with Taylor, then they put the pedal down, winning 45-6. Bainbridge a winner tonight. Appling County a big winner. And also in single A, Charlton County over Atco, 46-14 back upstairs.
All right, thank you, Nelly. 2:31 to go here. Cartersville down six, trying to punch it in for the game-tying touchdown. And then a PAT to go on top. And Hiram just used their first timeout. They have two remaining. Lando back in the game, going to get the handoff, and Lando going to walk right in for the touchdown. We're tied at 34.
Christian Lando finishing that off. That drive was all about Richard Houston and the backup running back. Lando gets the touchdown, just working down the line of scrimmage. Good block there by Connor Brassfield to get him in right here, as you can see, really untouched and getting in into the end zone.
And now the PAT after Hiram had their last attempt hit the upright. Ryan Johnson will try to put Cartersville on top. Snap back, get it down, it's up and it is good. And a 35-34 lead for Cartersville, 2:25 to go. Hiram gonna get it back one more time. Your Governor's Red Ribbon campaign scoring drive, 8 plays, 76 yards, most of that on the back of Richard Houston.
Great job by that offensive line in Houston. Big plays running up the middle, him breaking tackles to pick up extra yards after contact. And now Hiram Hornets, their backup quarterback, Ethan Lattimore. Yeah. You want to win the region, you have 2 minutes and 25 seconds. And when you got a kicker like Castaneda, that's all you need.
Yep.
In this situation,
you get it across the 50, you're in danger zone if you're Cartersville, if you let him get the ball to the 50. And because he's just missed on a 58-yard field goal, kicked at 57 and missed by a yard earlier in this game. Could come down to his foot. Houston had 55 of Cartersville's 76 yards on that last touchdown drive. And this is going to be non-returnable. So Hiram's going to start what might be their final possession of the night at their own 20-yard line. And down a point. They've never played Cartersville this close. In the three previous meetings, 18-point loss last year, 20-point loss in 2021, 25-point loss in 2020. But here they are, got the number one team within their sights. Cartersville trying to hold them off and get to 8-0 on the season.
Plenty of time, 2:25. You only need a field goal to win this game. You got two timeouts.
Hamilton gets to the outside and runs out of bounds. That'll stop the clock. But regardless of who wins this game, Wayne, it's going to be remembered here on GPB as the night of the running back.
Bring back the rushing attack.
This is like watching your alma mater, Auburn and Georgia, going at it back in the 1980s.
Official timeout.
So the official, they're having trouble with that chain tonight. Looks like it snapped off again.
Now, I'm going to be very impressed if one of them pull out a little screwdriver and is able to MacGyver that chain back together.
They're still working on it. That gives us a chance to check in with John again.
I do not have a screwdriver and cannot help the situation with any kind of a power drill, but we do have a final in 7A. Mill Creek knocks off Buford by the final of 31-24. I send that score back up to the booth with a question mark. Hey, guys, what do you think about that one?
Wow, that's the first regular season loss for Buford in 7A since they bumped up. Their loss last year came to Walton in the second round of the playoffs, and now Mill Creek, I guess. Yeah, who's going to be number one in our next GPB rankings? Does Mill Creek leapfrog? Does Colquitt County move up from number two? We shall see. And Walton's still unbeaten. Makes for an interesting final 3 weeks of the regular season. Stick around. End of the game. We're going to tell you where we're going to be next Friday night. It's going to be a fun one. To the air they go. And that's Matthews, the tight end, making the catch and stepping out of bounds as they're creeping their way down the field. But now it's going to be third down and five. You got to get the first down here.
Working on the edge, getting the ball to Matthews. Get out of bounds. Quick 5 yards there. You know you're going to play with all four downs on this drive to try to get this win. So conservative pass. Still have that one-on-one matchup down at the bottom there with Chase Tyler. So you got to be aware of him if you're a Purple Hurricane defender.
Third down and five. Lattimore wants to pass. Instead, he's going to run. He slides down short of the marker. And it's going to be fourth down.
Good job of reading the defense. The middle of the field opened up.
But he got to get the first down right there.
Looked like he thought he was at the marker, but came up short.
Hiram. That is their second charge timeout of the half.
Well, I mean, he comes up, he slides short of the marker, and here's the inexperience of the sophomore backup quarterback. You've got to get to the sticks there. And now you're fourth down. You just used your second timeout. That means if you don't get the first down here, game over. Because you're not going to have enough timeouts to help you out defensively and get the ball back. So you got to get the first down here or ball game Cartersville.
It's like we have about a fourth and two, came up 2 yards short on that.
Well,
you're right, Matt, as far as made the good read of reading the defense, but you got to know where you are on the field and when to slide and when to try to get that first down.
Well, I say ball game Cartersville, all likelihood. But after watching Miami and Georgia Tech, we can't ever say for sure, right? We can't ever say for sure.
Sometimes coaches outthink themselves.
So here you go. Fourth down and two. They got to get it to the 30. The hurricane warnings are sounding here at Wineman Stadium. Handoff goes to Hamilton. Hamilton, he's got the first down, or did he? The ball came out. They're going to rule him down at the 29, and that means the ball's going to go over on downs. Fumble came after he was down. Ball goes over to Cartersville, and the number one team in the state is likely held on for a big victory here tonight at home.
And this is a play that Hiram has used effectively all night long, going with a little jet sweep, get to the outside with Hamilton. Great job there by Kelson Mitchell, working down the line, shooting his gun, slicing through the defense, getting into the wheels of Hamilton, fumbling the ball, but was short of the first down regardless. And it looks like they maybe measure.
No, he's short.
It looks like they're going to.
Yeah, he's short.
He's
definitely short. And he was down by contact. He was reaching, trying to get the ball across the 30. And when he hit the ground, the ball popped out of his hands. But it doesn't matter. Either way, the ball goes over on downs to Cartersville.
And that was a bread and butter play.
Yeah.
That's a play that they've had a lot of success running that all night long in this game, coming up short on a big fourth down conversion.
Well, they're still over there helping. Young man off the field. That might be Cole Crawford. It is. I mean, this, we haven't called Cole's named much tonight. He is a freshman that is going to be one of the top prospects in the country in his career. Looks like they're holding that left arm. That does not look good. You hate to see that, but this is a young man who's rated as high as the number two catcher in baseball for the class of 2027. Outstanding football player. His dad, Ryan Crawford, the former head coach at Houston County High School, now running the middle school program here for Coach Connor Foster. He goes to the sideline. Hopefully he's going to be okay. But Cartersville, all they have to do here, they're not quite in a position to knee it all the way out, so you got to be careful, but they can take kind of a safety setup here. Hiram has one timeout remaining, so very little chance. And Hiram's going to use their last timeout.
Timeout, Hiram. That is their third and final charge timeout of the half.
So the math is going to start after this. And it seems like it's highly unlikely they're going to be able to get the ball back. But they did burn the timeout very quickly. They were quick on the draw there.
Still so strange to watch a four-minute offense, a two-minute offense that you're trying to kill the clock. Ran out of shotgun. It's still like
it
one
is,
of the, because you get so fearful with the snaps.
It just seems counterintuitive.
It's one of those things. And
we're going to be very safe here and shotgun snap it. I know. For those people who've been around football for a long time, it's still, like you said, it's a strange look.
Good job there by Lando, just getting the ball, two hands on the ball, shoulders down. And if you get a yard, you get a yard. But you cannot fumble this ball in this situation.
Handoff goes to Lando right up the middle, and he's going to slide down at the 11-yard line. What a smart play by that young man right there.
Great job there by that running back. What a great job he's at all night long. Not only so they can kill the clock, but to make sure in that last 8, 10 yards, nobody pulled the ball down. Just get down. Game over, and we go to celebration if you Cartersville.
Because if he scores there, that's going to give the Hornets the ball again and at least give them an opportunity. Very smart play by Lando there. Sliding down means they can knee it out from here on out. And Lando, 18 carries for 194. Clock is still running. Play clock's at 4. They might burn a timeout here once it gets down to 1. That's exactly what they do. And so Cartersville's going to call the timeout. 103 to go.
That is their second charge timeout of the half.
And all due respect to Coach Mario Cristobal and his offensive coordinator, there is no need for them to do anything other than knee it out here.
Most interesting part of that with Miami is who called the play. I was wondering how did the play get to the huddle, because there shouldn't have even been a play to run. But great job here of execution to try to win this game by Cartersville. You can just knee it out in this situation and take the victory.
Well, Cartersville is going to improve to 8-0 in the season, 3-0 in the region. They are clearly now in the driver's seat. It's the region is theirs to be won over the next 2 weeks, and they'll be at Woodland next Friday night. And a victory there, I think, would clinch it for them, since everybody else has a loss. And that would make what happens in the Dalton game. If they win at Woodland next week, I think they clinch the region championship. It would be their 24th all-time. And it would be their 11th in the last 12 years. And they are 64 seconds away from nailing this one down. They go into a victory formation. And again, you kneel out of a shotgun formation. And clean snap, knee taken, and there's nothing that Hiram can do about it right now.
Great game here tonight between these two teams. Hiram coming in, really confident that they could get this win, coming up a point short. But what a fight they put out on the field to try to conquer Cartersville and that in this region.
And road is tough for Hiram. They have not clinched a playoff spot. They're going to have to win out here, even though they've clinched the first winning season in program history since 2014. They still got work to do to get into the playoffs. It's a tough, tough region, a deep region, and a good team's going to get left out. But Cartersville will not be. They have all but punched their ticket to be the number one seed coming out of Region 7. They can clinch the region championship next Friday night at Woodland here tonight. What a battle. Third straight week, the Purple Hurricanes, the number one ranked team in the GPB Sports 5A Top 10. Third consecutive week, it has gone down to the last minute, last play of the game, and all 3 weeks, the Purple Hurricanes have found a way to win.
That tough grittiness that their coach, Connor Foster, talked about, he's loved about this team. They're a tight unit, physically running the ball tonight. Nate Russell finding the vertical game down the field. What a dangerous team, and the way they fly around on defense gives them a chance.
What a performance by Christian Lando tonight. 18 carries for 194, three touchdowns, had a 35-yard touchdown run, had a 66-yard touchdown run. Could have had a fourth touchdown there, but he put the team first. Thought, you know what? We don't need the touchdown. We want to win the game. Heads-up play by him to slide down and put the icing on the cake in this victory.
Yeah, I think Georgia State might want to drive that 50 miles and just come pick him up and take him back downtown. But what a display by that young man. Size and explosive speed tonight for some long touchdowns. Big plays all around for this offense. Really no more of a conversion offense. Really exploded to show big play capability.
So time now for the coach's interview. It's brought to you by Johnny's New York Style Pizza, your original neighborhood pizzeria. And John is standing by with the victorious head coach, Connor Foster.
We knew this region was tough. We figured it was going to be five teams in four spots. You were in the fight. I think you pretty much expected tonight.
Yeah, always. You know, great talent right here, Hiram, great coaching. We just got a tremendous region. So proud of our kids for being gritty tonight and finding a way in the second half to make a play.
And I think that that's probably the good adjective to use is gritty, because once again, you mentioned how Hiram and how they have improved over the last handful of years. I think that it was one of those moments where you were tested and you've come out the other side. I think it speaks a lot to what you've been able to do.
Sure. 3 weeks in a row. Couldn't be more proud of our kids. Just one score games 3 weeks in a row and just find ways to make plays down the stretch. Just again, very humbled by our kids' effort. Very proud of them.
What'd you learn about yourself tonight, you think?
I don't know if I learned anything about myself. God is good. I really appreciate our crowd for showing up big tonight in some tough conditions, and just really, really love this team, really love our leadership. We're getting better every week.
Now, Christian's our player of the game, but I want to ask about the guys up front that cleared the holes for him to get just shy of 200 yards on the night. What about that offensive line?
And they answered the call. You know, we challenged them this week. I thought last week we didn't play our best game up front. Really had a great week of practice and really proud of how those guys have responded.
Thanks for your time, and thanks for being great hosts all week.
Always. Thank you. Go Canes.
Connor, we'll do the hot tag. Coach's interview, as always, brought to us by our friends at Johnny's Pizza. Christian Lando just ran just south of 200 yards tonight. He's our player of the game, brought to us by our friends of the Georgia Cotton Commission. The Georgia Cotton Commission, the natural choice for Georgia, our natural choice for player of the game was this guy. What was it like out there? I mean, it was a gut check out there tonight, but what was it like?
I don't know. My team, like, we just had to rebound, and we've been tested so many times this season. I just really trusted everybody. I trusted the O-line to make holes. I just trusted everybody to just play the way we've been taught. And we had a really good week of practice on offense, and our offense been tested this whole season, and we really needed to come through. And when we came through, saw the result.
And you got a lot of chunk plays tonight, a lot of big yardage. Let me ask about that offensive line tonight for you. What was it like having all those big guys, the road graders up there, giving you those big chunk plays tonight?
And to be honest, I expected it out of them the whole season. And tonight, like a couple weeks ago, we ain't been playing our best, but tonight really showed how good we can be when we actually try.
And it's another, once again, it's another one of those tough games in this region for the third week in a row. You're having to go through this meat grinder that's out here. What's it been like this last couple of weeks?
Hey, bring it on. Bring it on. We're going to keep winning. We're going to keep playing. Bring it on. We got the hardest region in the state. Come on, keep playing.
That's a perfect ending for me. It's like, bring it on. So, once again, Christian Lando, player of the game, just shy of 200 yards on the ground tonight. Great offensive effort from our friends at Cartersville. Cartersville, big 35-34 win. Our natural choice for player of the game brought to us by our friends of the Georgia Cotton Commission. Christian, thanks for hanging out.
Thank you.
And he's going to go and celebrate, as he should, Matt. Matt, fantastic effort. Third week in a row in one of the toughest regions in the state, and Cartersville comes out the other side by 1 point.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Christian Lando, and I know, Wayne, as a former offensive lineman at Auburn in the NFL, you love the game tonight. You love the mindset with the Cartersville, both offensive lines did, and with all the running backs. We had three running backs over 100 yards rushing tonight.
Outstanding blocking up front by both lines. Christian Lando having a huge game. His backup, Richard Houston. Hey, when it's raining, when it's wet this time of year, you got to break out the run game. Both teams did. Cartersville did enough to get the victory.
Well, be sure to join us next Friday night. We're back in 7A, a big Region 4 matchup, as the Parkview Panthers take on the unbeaten Newton Rams in Covington, our first time ever there. For GPB Sports Football Fridays in Georgia, that's next Friday night at 7:30 right here on GPB TV. And our GPB Sports web game, we're going to be in Single A up in northeast Georgia, up by the lake, next Friday night as the Commerce Tigers take on the Elbert County Blue Devils. What a fun game that's going to be. That's our GPB Sports web game of the week next Friday night. Well, if you missed portions of tonight's game or just want to see it again, you can catch a full replay later this evening at 11:30 or in the coming week at gpb.org/sportsondemand. Once again, the final. Cartersville holds on to beat Hiram 35-34. Now for Wayne Gandy, John Nelson, Hannah Gooden, our executive producer, Kevin Gerke, game producer, Glenn Diamond, our director, Ryan Bowles. I'm Matt Stewart. Good night from Weinman Stadium in Cartersville. This has been a presentation of GPB Sports.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your grace got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna Healthcare. Cigna Healthcare is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna Healthcare's mission is to improve the health and vitality of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Just read the quarterback. Whatever way you're going, I'll follow. I usually follow your eyes. They throw it, and then I just catch it.
She's diving after flags, laying out for balls, things like that. Our team gets excited, and they just feed off of her energy, and it helps us win games.
The first couple of games, people really didn't take us seriously until they started seeing us win.
We are lucky enough to have won two state championships here at Southeast Bullock and to do it undefeated.
3 years ago, I never would have thought that playing flag football would have led me to going to college.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.